Improve flexibility and circulation. For incredible relief in just 20 minutes guaranteed, call Dr. Ho now. You'll get Dr. Ho's double massager, 4 comfort pads, 4 replacement gel pads, 2 clip-on cases, deluxe travel bag, the instructional video and manual, plus, for a limited time, Dr. Ho's supersized flex tone pads, a $30 value, free. All for just 3 payments of only $64.99. Try Dr. Ho. You have our 30-day money-back guarantee. Please have your credit card or checkbook ready when calling to order. Call right now and receive this exclusive bonus, Dr. Ho's new foot relief massage pads. Just plug them in and feel the instant relief of Dr. Ho's reflexology foot massage. For great relief in just 20 minutes guaranteed, call Dr. Ho now.
This was a paid presentation for Dr. Ho's double massage system and was brought to you by DrHoNow.com. The opinions expressed are those of
My arms help me a lot since I've been born. I've used my artificial arm to play around the schoolyard and all over and everywhere.
Warhamp's winner circle philosophy loop lives right up to that.
He never lets anything defeat him or overcome him.
Everything he does to his best ability.
When I went on the ice when I was 4, I wasn't quite good. I'm really fast now because I practiced and I practiced and I practiced over and over and over again. On it.
All the recreational.
Good morning, Manitoba. Thanks for joining us for our first ever CTV Morning Live. I'm Elanor Coopsammy.
I'm Kris Laudien. Lots coming up. We'll have news. Jesse Carlson is on the street with a view on traffic. And Terry Apostle will have your weather every 10 minutes.
Rochelle Legace will be live at Heritage Park School talking about school zone safety. And Kristen Hirsch will be tracking social media and all of your comments online.
But first, let's see what's making headlines in Winnipeg.
Winnipeg police remain tight-lipped about the city's latest murder.
A body is pulled from the Red River.
And a disappointing weekend for the Winnipeg Jets during preseason action. We'll have all the details on these stories and much more coming up.
But first, it's time to get a first check on weather with Terry Apostle. And Terry, when I went to the car this morning, I didn't see my breath, so that's a good sign.
No kidding. And you probably had an incredible weekend, too. We've been
gorgeous.
Dealing with just above normal temperatures for all of last week, and that trend is going to continue, too. I've got great news coming your way in the forecast. Right now, it is 10 degrees. We've got just a bit of a wind from the south. It's at 18 kilometers an hour, and the humidity at the moment, 91%. But a very mild morning right across the board. Everybody is waking up to a very clear morning. You can see the stars if you're out already. Sun's not up yet, but it's 9 degrees right now in Portage and in Brandon. 17 degrees in Dauphin. What an incredible temperature to be waking up to this morning. And those temperatures climbing throughout the day. As I mentioned, we'll be seeing above normal temperatures both here in the southern part of the province and northern Manitoba. We'll see some incredible temperatures as well around the mid-20 mark. So 22 degrees is our expected high here in Winnipeg. Sunshine right across the board, even in northern Manitoba. Partly sunny, so it's going to be a great day for everyone. And in fact, this week is going to be above normal for the most part. So a great week to look forward to, too. Our drive into work this morning is moving very well at the moment. This is a shot of McPhillips at Notre Dame. You can see traffic is still very, very light at the moment. No issues. We haven't heard of any stalls or crashes throughout the drive so far this morning. Traffic is very light. Around 7 a.m. we'll be seeing things building, but for the most part, it's a nice, easy start to your drive. We've also got Jesse out, and he's going to be checking traffic throughout the morning, too.
Well, good morning, Terry. Here's some good news and bad news. We'll start with the bad news. Kris, I can see my breath, which means I should get my jacket back on. Now, the good news is, and I can tell you as I flip around our camera here, very good news. Henderson Highway and Chief Peguis, this main intersection gave a lot of people problems Friday morning. I can tell you it's all clear and smooth, too. No bumps on your daily commute. Traffic is light right now, but it should increase as the morning goes on. That's it for now. Back to you, though.
Thanks, Jesse. It's 6:03. Checking the headlines. Police are investigating the city's 32nd homicide of the year. A man was found dead just before 4:30 yesterday morning in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor Streets. Police blocked off the street and set up a white tent for several hours as a homicide and identification units, along with the medical examiner, were on scene. Neighbors say they heard gunshots, but police won't confirm how the man died.
By and stated that there was an injured male at this location. We did get there. Our officers did arrive on scene and located an adult male who was, in fact, deceased.
Police say the investigation is in its early stages and won't say if it is gang-related. There is no word on the victim's name or how he died. Anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers.
A gruesome discovery along the banks of the Red River this weekend. Yesterday afternoon, a body was found in the water. Right now, police aren't giving any details about the gender or age of the person. We do know emergency crews were called out to the 2100 block of Henderson Highway near Knowles Avenue just before 2. Details are still emerging. Police won't say if it's connected to the drowning of 6-year-old Nathaniel Thurassi. He disappeared beneath the ice back in December. His body was not found. The Winnipeg Police Service Underwater Search and Recovery Unit is part of the investigation, which is continuing.
Police in Quebec are investigating the deaths of 3 adults over the weekend. They drowned trying to save their children from a raging river. The incident occurred Saturday near St. Fulgence along the Wapishish River. 2 boys waded too far into the water and got caught in the current. The fathers of the boys and one of their mothers jumped in to help. The boys were rescued, but the parents disappeared. The mother's body was retrieved almost immediately. The bodies of the men were found Sunday.
One of Russell Williams' sexual assault victims has filed a lawsuit against him. Williams' ex-wife and the Ontario Provincial Police are also being named in that legal filing. According to the Toronto Star, Lori Massicott was seeking more than $7 million in damages for pain, suffering, and mental distress. Massicott tells the Star that following her assault, police said she had to remain in restraints used by Williams as an OPP photographer documented the scene. Williams was sentenced to life in prison last fall for the murders of Corporal Marie-France Como and Jessica Lloyd, along with other crimes.
As fears grow of a global recession, markets around the world are falling. Overnight, it was Asia that saw a major sell-off. Stocks closed lower in Japan and Hong Kong. The Nikkei fell more than 2%. The Hang Seng dropped 1.5%. Wall Street and Bay Streets are coming off their worst week since the 2008 financial crisis. Toronto stock market lost 7%. Bank of Canada Governor Mark Carney warns the U.S. is not well positioned to deal with another financial crisis, but believes Canada is. Prime Minister Harper told the U.S. television network yesterday he believes another recession can be avoided if governments can restore business confidence.
It was a day to remember officers who lost their lives while protecting the lives of others. A bagpipe procession opened the Police and Peace Officers Memorial Service held at the Manitoba Legislature yesterday. It honors officers from a number of different services who were killed on the job. Winnipeg Police Chief Keith McCaskill read the names of the 8 Winnipeg police officers who lost their lives while on duty. Premier Greg Selinger commended all peace officers for putting their lives on the line.
So as we remember today those who have given that ultimate sacrifice, we can take a moment to reflect on what an important role they play in our society, a role of being in the front lines and challenging and protecting us from those that would, in some cases violently, take away those freedoms.
Similar ceremonies were held across the country. It was back in 1998 the federal government officially named the last Sunday of September as Police and Peace Officers Memorial Day.
The Winnipeg Jets play the Ottawa Senators tonight in St. John's, Newfoundland, home of the Jets AHL affiliate, the Whitecaps, after a weekend of losses. The Jets taking on the Carolina Hurricanes in Carolina yesterday afternoon, and it was a tough one for the Jets. Carolina walked away with a shutout, the final score 4-0. The Jets fired 36 shots at Cam Ward, but couldn't beat the Canes. With the loss, the Jets are 1-3 in the preseason, losing all three games on the road. And you want to make sure to stick around until 8:25 today. Our very first guest in studio is Winnipeg Jet forward Eric
Fair.
Very
exciting.
So we want you to send us your questions for the Winkler native. Tweet us at CTV Morning WPG, or you can email us at morningnews@ctv.ca.
Well, it's time now to check in with CTV's Rochelle Lagasse. She is down at Heritage School in St. James. What are you up to there today, Rochelle?
How are you guys doing?
Good.
Looking good, you guys.
Oh, thank you. So
thanks,
do you.
Rochelle.
Thank you. I'm standing right here, right in front of the school. And in fact, this is where kids get dropped off or picked up when they go to school or leave school. And CAA Manitoba wanted to see just how Winnipeg drivers did in these areas. So last Wednesday, they set up a three different Winnipeg schools and sat and watched drivers. And you guys won't believe the kinds of behaviors they caught, the sort of infractions they spotted in just 1 hour. In fact, they saw more than 530 infractions in just that 1 hour at those three schools. And you wouldn't even believe it. A man was shaving. A woman was waxing her eyebrows. I mean, come on, guys. We've all heard of people putting on lipstick when they're driving to work, but waxing your eyebrows, it's
ridiculous.
Just it's dangerous behavior as well, Elanor. And this is where children are running across the street. Sometimes, you know, they're excited. They might not be watching what they're doing.
Of course.
And it's very dangerous and just something that drivers need to remember when they are driving in these areas. So I'll have a little bit more about that study from CAA Manitoba.
That is interesting.
That is crazy. Thanks a lot, Rochelle. We'll be checking with Rochelle throughout the morning, waxing her eyebrows.
That's I've never heard of that one. That
amazing.
One's a first.
It's 6:09. Well, we all know pets are pretty special to a lot of people, but a woman didn't know what was going on when her pet crocodile turned orange.
This is unbelievable. Obviously, crocs are usually green, unless there's a species I don't know of that's out there. Let me know if there is.
Tracy Sandstrom of Geelong, Australia, thought her 8-foot-long croc, and she named it Snappy, which is appropriate, was sick when she noticed him turning a tint of orange.
Turns out Snappy sleeps in a heated bath at night, and he's bitten off one of the bath's water pipes, so I guess the damaged filter caused the water's pH to rise, and that's what she thinks turned him orange.
Okay.
Look at this guy.
Well, she was hoping to sell Snappy to a wildlife collector when he changed colors, but his strange new color didn't exactly faze the buyer. Experts say Snappy is healthy and should eventually turn back into his natural green coloring. That is
amazing.
I mean,
amazing, look at that
though.
Guy. He just looks angry.
Yeah, your pet crocodile. That's something we don't really have up here, but I guess in Australia, maybe that's not so out of the...
Well, that's why he's angry. They're teasing
the
him. Just give him the meat.
That's how you get a crocodile to move, though. You don't want... I mean, what other way are you going to get him to move? You can't put a leash on the guy.
I don't know. That's interesting. First of all, why would you want to have a pet crocodile? But
yeah, that's a whole
nother... To each his own.
Whole another story. Some like cats in Australia, they like, well, crocodiles. It's coming up to 6:11. Time now to get a check in on the weather. And I didn't see my breath this morning. Jesse said he saw his.
He called him out. He called you out on
we
it.
We need help on this. How warm is it out there right now?
You know, it's not a bad day at all. In fact, you can tell by taking a look outside. It's a very clear morning. Current condition right now, 10 degrees. So I wasn't seeing my breath. Maybe where Jesse is, it was a little bit cooler. Winds are from the south right now at 18 kilometers an hour. And the humidity sitting at 91%. Now, even if Jesse can see his breath at the moment, he won't later on today. Take a look at what we're going to be seeing for our high. 22 degrees is what we'll reach today. Lots of sunshine coming your way. And today, the winds will be from the south at 30 kilometers an hour. Now, overnight, things are going to drop down to about 10. That's our low, and winds will be tapering off slightly from the south at 15 kilometers an hour. And then for tomorrow, look at this. What an incredible day waiting for us. 24 degrees, lots of sunshine. And tomorrow, the winds will be from the west at 15 kilometers an hour. Now, taking a look at what we can expect for this week, by Wednesday, 23 degrees. 15 is normal for this time of year, so we'll be well above that. It will cool down slightly for the latter part of the week, 17 expected for Thursday, 16 for Friday, but even our weekend looking very good and still staying above normal for this time of year with 19 and 17 expected for Saturday and Sunday. So the long-range forecast is looking great.
Nothing wrong with that. That keeps me happy.
Love seeing those sunshines.
Well, still to come. The latest from the provincial campaign trail is next on CTV Morning Live.
And a new lifeline for pet owners. The new program to help get lost dogs back with their owners.
CTV Morning Live with Kris Laudien. Weekday mornings from 6 to 9. Now for a look at what's up in Manitoba.
Experience upcoming fashion trends at Lights, Camera, Fashion, hosted by fashion expert Jeannie Becker. The event takes place Wednesday, October 19th at Canadian's Polo Park, with all proceeds going to the Children's Wish Foundation of Canada to fund future children's wishes. For more information, visit lightscamerafashion.ca.
Submit your public service announcement online at ctvwinnipeg.ca. The 60-Second Driver.
Manitoba school patrols help young pedestrians cross the street safely. As drivers, we must help them do their job.
If you see a school patrol at an intersection, other kids are likely nearby. The first thing you should do is slow down.
School patrols are not there to control traffic. Their duty is to control when kids should cross the street. They wait for drivers to stop, then let kids cross when it's safe.
A driver should keep their foot on the brake and proceed only when the kids are on the sidewalk and the patrol has returned to the curb.
2011 is the 75th anniversary of school patrols in Manitoba. Greenway School, one of the first to offer the programs, and others across the province are helping to keep kids safe. Do your part and slow down.
School patrols have done a great job keeping kids safe from traffic collisions. And with your help, we'll continue to do so for many years to come.
This message brought to you by Manitoba Public Insurance and CTV.
People with type 2 diabetes or pre-diabetes don't have to give up their favorite foods or prepare separate family meals or treats.
And more than ever before, food companies like Kraft are committed to helping adults and children enjoy healthy eating. So here's a delicious recipe for turkey apple sliders that everyone can enjoy. They're easy to make and fun to eat. Start by heating the barbecue to medium-high. Mix ground turkey, a grated Granny Smith apple, crushed whole wheat crackers, thyme, and sage, then shape into small patties and barbecue. Garnish with a whipped dressing, add the burger, and a piece of light cheese.
If you'd like more delicious recipes like this that are also approved by the Canadian Diabetes Association, check out our website.
Until next time, keep fit and have fun.
Body break.
Closed captioning for this program is brought to you by The Keg Steakhouse and Bar. Great steaks, good friends. See you tonight.
Good morning. You're watching CTV Morning Live. Already 9 degrees in Winnipeg. Highs expected of 22 today. So if you can get outside and enjoy the day, definitely do that. A trial is slated to start today into the killing of an Interlake man murdered back in 2007. 43-year-old Ivan Radokaj was found murdered in his home near Inwood in September 2007. RCMP say he died of blunt force trauma. A total of 6 people were charged in his death, including Radokaj's ex-wife, who was charged with conspiracy to commit murder. CTV's Stacey Ashley will be at the courthouse today. We'll have more on the trial later today on CTV News. Police are investigating the city's 32nd homicide of the year. A man was found dead just before 4:30 yesterday morning in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor Streets. Police blocked off the street and set up a white tent for several hours as a homicide and identification units, along with the medical examiner, were on scene. Neighbors say they heard gunshots, but police won't confirm how the man died. On the election front today, NDP leader Greg Selinger will spend some time at the Winnipeg Indoor Soccer Complex before heading to Fisher Branch for a health care announcement. And Progressive Conservative leader Hugh McFadden will hit the doors in St. Vital after making his announcement of his own yesterday. The Liberals released some green initiatives. Liberal leader John Girard unveiled his eco plan for the province. If elected, Girard would reduce phosphorus in Manitoba lakes, protect space for community gardens, and invest in a green economy. In your home, Girard said they would also phase out phosphorus and dishwasher detergents and invest in a composting program. The plan would cost $4 million. And a few hundred party faithful attended an NDP rally inside the Park Theatre yesterday afternoon. NDP leader Greg Selinger bolstered the crowd by outlining his election plan and took some jabs at PC leader Hugh McFadden. Meanwhile, McFadden attended Temple at the Sikh Society of Winnipeg yesterday morning. Later, he attended the Winnipeg Sun editorial board meeting. The Brandon University Faculty Association will vote this week on whether to hit the picket lines. Ballots are being mailed out today to the 240 association members. Officials expect the strike to take about a week to 10 days to complete. The association president says contract negotiations will continue during that time. At issue are salary, benefits, and contract language. The mystery of a Montreal-born woman whose body was found encased in concrete has taken another turn. Yesterday, Randy Lehrer's American husband, Stephen Lacuna, was charged with murder. The arrest came one day after neighbors held a vigil outside the New Jersey apartment building where the victim lived with her husband and daughter. It's also where Lehrer's remains were found Friday, 6 weeks after Lacuna reported her missing. Her body will be returned to Montreal for a funeral. It's being called an Amber Alert for dogs. A group of Winnipeg volunteers is trying something new to get lost dogs back to their families. It's a Facebook called Winnipeg Lost Dog Alert. As soon as a dog is reported missing on site, a picture, description, and where the dog was last seen is sent out to a network of people. The volunteers then start searching for the lost pet. The group says they've found 50 lost dogs since the beginning of the year.
Not knowing where they are, and it's crazy. Yes, it's that's why we feel so good. It's the reward of the person getting their dog back. That is our, that's what we do it for.
People that don't even know each other but just have a love of animals are now going out and searching for some total stranger's animal. I think it's fantastic.
It's now law to license dogs in Winnipeg. The Humane Society says it's important to make sure your dog has a tattoo, microchip, or collar tag in case it gets lost. The Brad Pitt drama Moneyball failed to make the cut at the box office this weekend as Disney's re-release of The Lion King reigns supreme for a second week.
Kuna Matata, ain't no peasant craze.
The Lion King, which was released in 3D, made just over $22 million. That edged out Pitt's baseball drama Moneyball, which took in $20.6 million. And debuting in third spot, the feel-good family film Dolphin Tale, it made just over $20 million. But how pleased is Disney with a 17-year-old movie winning the box office 2 weeks in a row?
And it's going to be released on DVD on October 4th. I'll be going to get that one.
Oh, that's amazing. And I finally just got that song Hakuna Matata out of my head.
I know,
and
now
17
now it's
years later. It's back up there.
Well, it is 6:19, and that's time now to take a quick peek at traffic. So, Terry Apostle, what do we got going on for traffic?
Well, I can tell you that Hakuna Matata pretty much sums up what we are seeing in traffic right now. No worries at all. It's very light at the moment. Things moving very, very easily. In fact, we're going to take a look at one of our traffic cameras right now. This is a shot of the Disraeli overpass. Now, for the past week or so, we've been dealing with problems on Henderson Highway, which lead into the Disraeli overpass. But look at this. At the moment, traffic moving very easily in this stretch. It's all looking very, very good. We've also got Jesse out on the street, keeping a closer eye on how things are moving. Jesse, how's your drive?
Well, good morning, Terry, and good morning to everyone out there. The drive is going very nicely so far. Now, earlier I was telling you about that Henderson-Chief Peguis intersection, how things are a lot better than what it was on Friday. Now, if you're continuing to travel on Henderson Highway towards the city, you will notice delays like we did on Friday, Main Street on the Disraeli Bridge. So you might want to hang over to Main Street if you want your drive a little more smoother than normal. Well, check us out on Twitter and send us a traffic tip, stalls or crashes at CTV Morning. WPG, drop us a line and let us know what you see. That's it for now. Back to you.
So it's all good news on the drive, and in fact, the forecast is looking good, too. Let's take a look at our current conditions right now. It's 9 degrees in Winnipeg, 8 in Portage de la Prairie, 17 in Dauphin. This is just incredible. I can't believe what a mild morning it is, and even in areas to the north, too. 14 right now in the Paw, 15 in Flin Flon, 12 in Thompson. This is just unbelievable weather that we're still experiencing for our first week of fall. Now, taking a look at this, you can see this is our satellite image, and it'll show what's coming our way over the next couple of days. Just a little bit of cloud coverage, not quite reaching
us here in Winnipeg, we're pretty much going to have a sunny day, and even that cloud coverage is pretty much going to bypass us. Moving right through in the overnight hours, it continues on, but for the most part, no precipitation, just a little bit of light cloud coming away every now and then, but everywhere in the province is going to be mainly sunny for the next couple of days, and in fact, for the next week too. Look at this. We've got gorgeous temperatures, 22 expected for today, 24 for tomorrow, 23 for Wednesday. It's just looking fantastic. We do have a high pressure ridge hanging over us right now, which is giving us these warmer than normal temperatures. It will move a little bit further east, and that's why you're seeing things lowering just a little bit by the latter part of the week. Things will be looking more, well, closer to normal, but still a little bit above that. So no complaints here in the forecast. We also have some lovely weather pictures to show you. Thank you very much to Connie Norris. This was sent in from Morris, a beautiful shot of the sunset. And look at that, a bald eagle on a beautiful blue seeming summer day, but this was actually taken in the fall. Gorgeous weather that we're still experiencing. Keep sending those pictures to us, please. Winnipegweather@ctv.ca. We're taking a break, but we'll be back in a moment with more CTV Morning Live.
Your alarm system was off and no evidence of forced entry.
So maybe someone they knew.
Where's the kid?
When you remember everything.
Cell phone.
There's a hamster named Smith. It records what you say.
Every second counts.
Unfortunately, we can't bring what's in your head to a judge.
But when a child is involved,
he recorded the murder.
The stakes are even higher.
He saw the killer.
A new episode of Unforgettable. Tomorrow at 10, 9 central on CTV.
Jackpot. Name the cut of meat that's often called the king of beef.
I'd like to call my buddy Marty.
You sound confident.
He's a butcher.
Come on, it's prime rib.
Let's get him on the line.
It's prime rib, right?
Yes. Yes, it is.
It seems Marty's preoccupied.
The Prime Rib Grandma Burger. It's burger bliss.
Joy of childhood, at any age, for you, for her, for generations, Wonder Bread has been your favorite. And now it's free of artificial preservatives, free of artificial colors, free of artificial flavors. What other bread makes you feel this free? New Wonder Bread, the same fresh taste you love, baked fresh daily, for joyful nutrition.
Everyone loves designer fall fashions, but you deserve great value, too. No problem. Use Fashionomics, where brand name fashion and economical prices come together. You can get double the designer fashions for your money at Winners. Because hundreds of brand names are always up to 60% less. Winners, find fabulous for less.
Yeah, breaker, breaker. Directions for Fountain Tires, 4 for $3 sale, over.
Get 4 selected Goodyear tires for the price of 3. Another reason to trust Fountain Tire.
So is that a left at the...
This is it. The turn of the chair. The moment my clients fall in love with their styles. And they want to make it last past the salon. So I recommend Tresemme, Canada's number one hairspray. The salon quality performance goes long on hold, never losing a grip on style. For a superior hold and touchable feel that you can see won't let you down. Get all day long, salon gorgeous, chair-worthy hair without the salon price. Tresemme, professional, affordable.
Good morning, it's 6:25. You're looking at a shot of Portage Avenue. Traffic going pretty lightly right now. And stick around because we're going to have some tickets to give away for Avril Lavigne.
Yeah, big
but
giveaway. But first, it's time to go over to the web desk for our first check-in with Kristen Hirsch. Kristen, you're manning the web desk. How are things going this morning at ctvwinnipeg.ca?
Well, do you know what? Traffic outside doesn't look very busy, but traffic on the web is quite busy this morning. High volumes. And normally I walk you through the top three stories on the web so you don't feel behind at the water cooler. You know what's going on at work. But I'm going to go a little bit rogue here this morning and give you an overview of all of our beautiful interaction on the website. Are you two ready for this?
I'm ready.
Are you excited?
Bring it on.
We are. All right. So first things first, this is our main website, which is CTVWinnipeg.ca. What you're going to want to look for is these two beautiful people right here, and you're going to want to click on them. It's going to take you to this site. Check it out. Here we all are. As you can see, Kris is the one guy right here. It's a toilet seat down.
There's Jesse. Jesse's there too.
Isn't he cute? He just bumped right in there. It's a toilet seat down kind of studio. Kris and his ladies, and Jesse, of course, out on track. So here we go. Here you can see everything, an overview of the show. Okay, we're going to move along. Here is our Facebook page, all interaction. I'm actually going to do a live Facebook post right now. Are you guys ready for this?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
We want to know what we should ask our special guest today, Eric Fair. So I'm going to put that up there. Go to our Facebook page, CTV Morning Live Winnipeg. There it is. And finally, our Twitter page and our handle.
We're everywhere.
Everywhere. If you want us, you can get us. CTV Morning WPG, that is our handle. I actually had to teach my boss what a handle was, and that in fact is what a handle is called. It is attached to our Twitter account. So there you have it. That is how you reach us, because you two get to have each other, but I basically have my co-host in Winnipeg. I want you to be my co-host,
right?
And talk to me, and I'll moderate, so.
All right, thanks a lot, Kristen. Okay. We'll be checking with Kristen at the web desk throughout the whole morning.
Well, still to come, Rochelle Legace is at Heritage Park School. She'll be talking about school zone safety right after the break.
Cigarettes, sir.
Bless you.
Major John McCrae, surgeon, born and raised in Guelph, Ontario.
Poppies. Now, blow. Between crosses, roll on the road. If ye break faith. Ye shall not see.
Mr. McCrae?
In Flanders fields.
What is it?
I'm not sure.
John McCrae of Montreal died in the war. But his poem is still spoken aloud when men, women, and children gather to remember.
For the jackpot, name the cut of meat that's often called the king of beef.
I'd like to call my buddy Marty.
You sound confident.
He's a butcher.
Come on, it's prime rib.
Let's get him on the line.
It's prime rib, right?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Seems Marty's preoccupied.
The Prime Rib Grandma Burger. It's burger bliss.
Wanted. Curious. Free. Thinking. People. Confident and independent. Who prefer what they see to what they're told. Liquid metal design. Cabin quiet tuning. Available hands-free now. The Buick Regal. Enclave and the Cross. Buick. Unexpected.
If you catch the news as it happens, we want the world to see it. Send it to our website. Click on My News and we'll put it online. Your pictures, your video. My News.
Get breaking news sent straight to your desktop with CTV News at Work and the day's top stories on Twitter. Visit ctvwinnipeg.ca. Manitoba's news leader covers the stories you need to watch. And the best way to see them is just a click away. Visit ctvwinnipeg.ca.
Thanks for joining us on our very first show here at CTV Morning Live. I'm Kris Laudien.
And I'm Elanor Coopsammy. We have lots coming up today. Traffic, news. We have weather every 10 minutes for you to tune in for that as well. And we have Kristen Hirsch at the web desk.
At the web desk. Yeah, it's a really interactive show. We want to get you involved. So if you want to email us at morningnews@ctv.ca, go ahead. We want to feel, you know, see what you think of the show for sure. We'll get to all that and introduce you to the rest of the team throughout the morning. But first, let's take a look at the headlines.
Well, Winnipeg police investigate investigate the 32nd homicide of the year after a man was found dead in the North End.
Tragedy in Quebec as three adults drowned trying to save their children.
And a local university serves up some food for thought. We'll have all the details on that story and so much more coming up shortly. But first, here's Terry.
That's right. We're going to the roof to check in with Terry. No ice on the windshield this morning. I know that much, Terry.
That's right, Kris. A beautiful morning. I can look out on the horizon and just begin to see the beginnings of the sun, which we will see plenty of later today. Lots of sunshine coming your way right across the province. And we're waking up to 9 degrees at the moment. Winds are from the south at 17 kilometers an hour. The humidity at 93%. Now, we've got 9 degrees here in Winnipeg, but there are some places who are having an incredible morning. Like, check out this, 17 degrees right now in Dauphin. It's 14 in the Paw, 12 right now in Thompson. So gorgeous weather for central and northern Manitoba. Everybody will be seeing a little bit of sunshine today. And here in Winnipeg, we're expecting to reach a high of 22 degrees. Not a bad day, keeping in mind that 15 is normal for this time of year. We're going to be well above that for today, tomorrow, the next couple of days, right into the middle of the week, where things will start to taper down a little bit as far as the searing temperatures go. But still staying above normal. So an incredible forecast coming your way. On our drive, it's also pretty easy at the moment. This is a shot of Portage Avenue. You can see it's just the early birds out so far. No major crashes or stalls on our drive. Nothing really slowing you down just yet. Everything is looking good. But we've also got Jesse out taking a closer look at how your drive is going. We'll check in with him in the dash cam.
Well, good morning, Terry. Yeah, live from the dash cam here. We're driving southbound on Henderson Highway right now. And if this is your daily commute, you will agree with me that this intersection was crazy last week because of the construction going on. Everything is clear. No sights of anybody working from the city around this area. So whether you're coming off the Chief Peguis or coming into the city, southbound on Henderson Highway, your daily commute is going smooth so far. Back to you at the station.
Thanks, Jesse. The time is 6:32. Winnipeg police are not yet saying much as they investigate the city's 32nd homicide. Just before 4:30 yesterday morning, a man was found dead in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor Streets. Police blocked off the streets and set up a white tent for several hours. Neighbors say they heard gunshots, but police won't confirm exactly how the man died. There's no word on the victim's name, and anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers.
The arson unit is investigating another arson in the Elmwood area. This is what it looks like in the back lane of the 100 block of Talbot Street. Fire crews were called out just after 4 a.m. yesterday morning. A garage and two vehicles near the garage were burned, bringing the damage estimated up to about $40,000. This is the latest in a string of suspected arsons in the area over the past couple of weeks. The arson unit is looking into the cause. Anyone with information is asked to call police.
Well, police in Quebec are investigating the deaths of three adults over the weekend. They drowned trying to save their children from a raging river. The incident occurred Saturday near St. Fulgence along the Wapishish River. Two boys waded too far into the water and got caught in the current. The fathers of the boys and one of their mothers jumped in to help. The boys were rescued, but the parents disappeared. The mother's body was retrieved almost immediately. The bodies of the men were found on Sunday.
One of Russell Williams' sexual assault victims has filed a lawsuit against him. Williams' ex-wife and the Ontario Provincial Police are also being named in that legal filing. According to the Toronto Star, Lori Massacault was seeking even more than $7 million in damages for pain, suffering, and mental distress. Massacault tells the Star that following her assault, police said she had to remain in restraints used by Williams as an OPP photographer documented the scene. Williams was sentenced to life in prison last fall for the murders of Corporal Mary France Como and Jessica Lloyd, along with others.
Now to Saudi Arabia, where a long-standing policy that evoked controversy around the globe has been changed. The Arab Kingdom has finally granted women the right to vote. King Abdullah made the historic announcement over the weekend. Along with the right to vote, women will also be allowed to run as candidates. This is in a country where women are still not legally allowed to drive.
While some cafeterias argue a healthier menu eats into their profits, one local school calls it a recipe for success.
Broccoli, mushrooms, hard-boiled egg, celery.
In the heart of our downtown, the University of Winnipeg is serving up a healthy and tasty menu that still includes some student favorites with a twist. On the menu, menu, you'll find salads and stir fries, along with chicken fingers and hamburgers and fries. But what makes it different is that the fries are hand cut and the bread is whole wheat. Since changing its menu, the UAW says sales are up by 20%, and the healthy concept is drawing attention. Other schools have already contacted the university about the program.
We're doing it all from scratch. We're sourcing locally. We're using organic as much as possible. And it's real food as opposed to processed.
Since changing its menu, the UAW says sales are up by 20%, and the healthy concept is drawing attention. Other schools have already contacted the university about the program.
It's 6:36. American swimmer Diana Nyad has ended her latest attempt to become the first person to swim between Cuba and Florida without a shark cage. 62-year-old Nyad was halfway through when stings from a Portuguese man-of-war jellyfish temporarily paralyzed her spine. Doctors also warned her another sting could be life-threatening. Nyad made another try last month but had to quit because of shoulder pain and an asthma attack.
It's a game head coach Paula Police said his team should have won. The Bombers remain the best in the CFL despite suffering a single point loss to the league's last place team, the Argonauts. The 25-24 loss Saturday in Toronto was costly in more ways than one. Seven Bombers were unable to finish the outing, including quarterback Buck Pierce. The Bombers starter re-aggravated his bruised ribs and was forced to leave the game prior to the half. Also injured in the contest, backup QB Alex Brink, who left in the fourth quarter after he injured his shoulder on his non-throwing arm. Third string pivot Justin Goltz entered the game without a single pass to his name this season. Meanwhile, running backs Fred Reed and Carl Volney left the game with knee injuries. Offensive lineman Brendan Labatt and defensive lineman Doug Brown and Rodney Fritz didn't complete the game as well. This is sounding morbid. The Bombers will reevaluate each injured player over the next 2 days, but the top concern is Pierce, who is questionable for Friday's East Division showdown against Montreal. That's a huge game.
Very disappointing on the weekend.
Definitely a huge game.
Well, we'll wait for Montreal. Hopefully things will turn around.
Still in first place. So right now it's time to turn our attention to CTV's Rochelle Legacy. She's on location talking about crosswalk safety this morning in school zones.
That's right, Kris. And I'm joined right now by Liz Peters with CAA Manitoba. Liz, you did the study last Wednesday, right? What did you find?
Last Wednesday when we did the school zone assessment, what we found in three different school zones in the city is that motorists are taking risks. They're doing things like distracted driving, stopping over the stop line, not using turn signals when they're changing lanes, which takes away from the fact that there's pedestrians in those school zones, and if you don't know what a car is going to do, if you don't have a little bit of heads-up notice that they're going to be changing lanes or if they're stopping over the stop line, it's causing some problems. And the children are our most vulnerable road users. It's upon the motorist's responsibility to be a little bit more safe when they're in school zones.
This was just in 1 hour, and you recorded 535 infractions. Were you surprised by this?
You know, I think that we weren't necessarily surprised. We were surprised by some of the things that we saw people doing. For the distracted driving in particular, we all know that it's a problem, but I was pretty shocked that we saw one person shaving. We saw lots of people talking on their cell phones and texting messages. We saw one person even waxing their eyebrows, and another person reading a book behind
what?
The wheel. Yeah, this was, I mean, if it's at a red light, you might think that it's okay, but the legislation that was brought in Manitoba just over a year ago says that it's not okay.
So obviously that's shocking, but even reading a book, you're kind of slower when you're looking up and down and up and down.
Definitely.
Right?
We always say eyes on the road, hands on the wheel, and if you're not doing that, then you're distracted. If you're distracted, you're not going to notice you're entering a school zone. You're not going to see that there's a kid crossing the street.
So now that you have this information, what do you hope to do with it?
Well, one thing that CAA wants to do, and we've been involved in the school patrol program for more than 60 years here in Manitoba, one thing we want to do is go to the schools. We want to talk to the teachers, we want to talk to the parents, and we also want to talk to the motorists who live in and around and are driving through school zones. We want to talk to them about how they can educate themselves, how they can be as safe as possible, because once again, our children are our most vulnerable road users, and if they are not aware of what's going on around them, it's our responsibility to be doing that.
And so you're actually going to schools in Manitoba and telling patrollers or kids as they cross the street how to be road wary? Is that what you're trying to do?
Yeah, well, I mean, the kids is one part of it. We can, we all know kids, and we all know that they're not necessarily always remembering everything we tell them or doing everything that they're told. So we do as much as we can to educate the kids, thus the school safety patrol program. Right. But educating the motorists, and we forget those little things like stopping a foot over a stop line at a red light is illegal. What if a kid was crossing in front of the car? That's very, very dangerous. So little things that you really need to keep in mind when you're passing, especially through school zones, is exactly what we're going to try to educate educate motorists to be doing.
And so later on, we're going to talk to patrollers, hopefully, and a principal, possibly, who can talk about the dangers that he witnessed as well, and what this means day to day at school, and what he wants drivers to know. So that's coming up later.
Thanks, Rochelle. We appreciate that.
Well, it's 6:41. Time now to turn our attention to the Weather Center. Terry, it was a gorgeous weekend. Is that kind of temperature and sunshine going to continue?
It is, Kris. Although I just have to say, it takes me at least 20 minutes to recover from an eyebrow waxing. I can't imagine being ready to go when the light turned green, right? I'd still be like, ah!
I know, that was shocking.
Eyes on the road, people, especially in the school zones. That's where our most vulnerable are.
Definitely. I can't comment on that, but I'll trust you on that.
All right, let's take a look now at our current conditions. Outside, it's 9 degrees, south winds 17 kilometers an hour, and the humidity at 93%. Taking a look at our satellite image, you can see nothing is showing up, and that's great news. That means nothing but sunshine is in store for us here. You can take a look at what we're expecting across the province for our highs today, and it's looking great. 20s to above for northern Manitoba, some sunshine peeking through there. These are great temperatures, keeping in mind, of course, that 16 is normal for this time of year. Look at that, 25 for Lynn Lake, 24 for Flin Flon and the Paw, Norway House 23. It's looking very, very good. We've also got 24 degrees expected for Dauphin, for Brandon, for Swan River, 25. Lots of sunshine, and take a look at this. Here in Winnipeg, 22 degrees is our high. That's what we'll be seeing, too, in Gimli, Portage, Morden, Winkler, Sprague. Even on Ontario, getting plenty of sunshine today, just a little bit cooler, 20 and 21 degrees. Here's a look at your long-range forecast, and it, too, is looking very good. 22 degrees for today, 24 for tomorrow, and staying above normal for this time of year right into the weekend.
All good to hear. Thank you, Terry. Well, our very first in-studio guest is Winnipeg Jet Eric Fair, and he'll be with us just before 8:30 this morning.
That's but right.
First, we want you to send us your questions for the Winkler native. Tweet us at CTV Morning Winnipeg or email us at morningnews@ctv.ca.
Still ahead, a new show that premiered on CTV last night is trending on Twitter today. Kristen Hirsch will have more on that coming up.
Plus, why a number of former Montreal Canadiens star hit the ice in Quebec's eastern townships.
My spidey senses are tingling.
The truth is sometimes stranger than fiction.
Our killer is a superhero.
NYPD, do not move a muscle.
Unless you can move faster than a speeding bullet.
This man, he's our killer.
And it takes a seasoned writer.
How cool was that?
With special skills.
Our killer is the writer of this comic book.
NYPD, take off that mask.
To read between the lines.
I did not see that coming.
An all-new Castle. Tonight at 10, 9 Central on CTV.
You've got a lot on your plate at Thanksgiving, which is why Safeway has everything you need to get it all done. Right now, you can get a grade A frozen turkey under 7 kilograms for just 99 cents a pound. That's our promise. That's ingredients for life. Safeway.
Kids are happy when they get to choose, like choosing to do nothing or do one thing all day long or discovering something new. And now with the Danino strawberry yogurt in every McDonald's Happy Meal, side options like mini fries, apple slices, even 1% white milk in a cool little jug. Moms can feel even better because their kids have nutritious options to choose from. McDonald's Happy Meals, now with even more happy.
With the professional independent advice of a licensed insurance broker working for you, you can sleep easy. Insurance brokers don't work for an insurance company. They find you the best insurance, getting you the right coverage at the right price, and are there to help in the event of a claim, so you can sleep easy. Your best insurance is an insurance broker.
130,000. That's how many children are treated every year at Children's Hospital. And each case is as much about healing as it is about learning and sharing. That's why once a month, CTV News and the Children's Hospital Foundation of Manitoba will share the latest findings on health issues affecting children. Whether you're a parent or not, chances are you've been touched by the joy a child can bring. Watch for Small Wonders, the last Thursday of every month on CTV News.
In other words, you are loved. Dogs don't have just one way into our hearts. So why give them just one boring taste? Kibbles and Bits has crunchy kibbles with real meaty bits that dogs love. So every bite tastes delicious. Kibbles and Bits. The bits make it better.
Good morning. It's 6:46. A gruesome discovery along the banks of the Red River this weekend. Sunday afternoon, a body was found in the water. Right now, police aren't giving any details about the gender or age of the person. We do know emergency crews were called out to the 2100 block of Henderson Highway near Knowles Avenue just before 2. Details are still emerging, but police won't say if it's connected to the drowning of 6-year-old Nathaniel Thorassi. He disappeared beneath the ice back in December. His body hasn't been found. The Winnipeg Police Service Underwater Search and Recovery Unit is part of the investigation, which is ongoing. Police are investigating the city's 32nd homicide of the year. A man was found dead just before 4:30 yesterday morning in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor. Police blocked off the street and set up a white tent for several hours as the homicide and identification units, along with the medical examiner, were on the scene. Neighbors say they heard gunshots, but police will not confirm how the man died.
A passerby who had walked by and stated that there was an injured male at this location. We did get there. Our officers did arrive on scene and located an adult male who was, in fact, deceased.
Police say the investigation is in its early stages and won't say if it is gang-related. There is no word on the victim's name. Anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers. The Brandon University Faculty Association will vote this week on whether to hit the picket lines. Ballots are being mailed out today to the 240 association members. Officials expect the strike vote to take about a week to 10 days to complete. The association president says contract negotiations will continue during that time. At issue are salary, benefits, and contract language. Well, with Election Day quickly approaching, there are a few tight races political observers are closely watching. In Brandon West, only 56 votes separated the Progressive Conservatives from the NDP in the last election. MLA Rick Borotzik is not seeking re-election, and a Brandon University political scientist says the new candidates could face a similar outcome. The PC candidate in Brandon is businessman Reg Helwer. The NDP have former Brandon School Board Chair Jim Murray. Rounding out the candidates are teacher George Burry for the Liberals and Lisa Gallagher for the Communists. The candidates say the main issues in the riding include infrastructure, violent crime, education, and health care. In Winnipeg, NDP leader Greg Selinger will visit the indoor soccer complex before heading to Fisher Branch for a health care promise. And Tory leader Hugh McFadden will campaign in St. Vital after making his own announcement. Then tonight, candidates in Point Douglas will speak on topics of housing, poverty, crime, and health. The candidates forum at the Indian and Métis Friendship Centre on Robinson Street starts at 5 today with a community feast and ends at 9. Thousands of activists and others are expected to converge on Parliament Hill today. They're set to take part in a protest against the oil sands and the building of a massive pipeline from Alberta to Texas. In Washington last month, more than 1,000 people, including celebrities, were arrested during a huge protest against the Keystone XL pipeline at the White House. The Harper government says the project would bring thousands of jobs, but environmentalists fear oil spills along the pipeline route will cause irreversible damage. A new arena is now open in Quebec's eastern townships, bearing the name of a legendary hockey coach. Pat Burns died last year after a long battle with cancer. The arena opened yesterday in style with a game featuring former Habs star. Burns was an NHL Coach of the Year 3 times, and he saw the New Jersey Devils win the Stanley Cup.
It was an emotional day for me. He was so involved with young kids and had, you know, the wellness kids at heart.
That was Burns' widow expressing her pride in the new announcement. The new arena will offer hockey camps 12 months a year.
Yeah, great story, Pat Burns. As a former policeman turned NHL
coach.
Yes,
that's right. Yeah. I had read that somewhere.
Coached some great franchises, Toronto, Montreal, Boston.
Very nice honor for his family.
Definitely very nice. Well, it's 6:51. That means it's time to check in at the Weather Center with Terry Apostle. Yesterday, Terry, I was at Assiniboine Park walking around, basking in the sunshine. Are we going to expect some more of that temperature?
Kris, yes, and you weren't the only one out at Assiniboine Park yesterday. Of course, it was the free weekend at the zoo. Everybody seemed to be there. What a busy day. And just, yes, as you said, soaking up those incredible temperatures. Well, we've got another great day coming your way. Take a look first at our current conditions. 9 degrees here in Winnipeg. It's still very mild in Dauphin. 17 degrees as we move further north. Still very mild temperatures. 14 in the Paw, 15 for Flin Flon, and 12 for Lynn Lake, Thompson, and Island Lake. Here's a look at what we can expect today. As you put the kids on the bus, about 9 degrees, so they will need a sweater, but they'll probably be ditching it a little later in the day. 18 degrees expected by noon. Today, the winds will be from the south around 20 to 30 kilometers an hour, and reaching our high by about 3:30 today. 22 degrees. The kids will be ditching the sweater by then as they head home on the bus. Take a look at this. The long-range forecast looking very good, showing 22 for today, 24 for tomorrow, above normal right through the week and into the weekend. This is gorgeous. Lots of sunshine in there, too. So an incredible week coming our way. Our first full week of fall, and it's looking very, very good. Our drive is also looking very good this morning. This is a shot of Disraeli. You can see that traffic is still fairly light. It's starting to pick up a little bit for southbound commuters. Now, I do want to draw your attention, though, to Henderson Highway, where we had some big delays over the past couple of days, right in here at Chief Peguis Trail. We had Jesse take a look at that spot this morning. He says the barricades are down, so it shouldn't be a big trouble spot on your drive. So thank goodness for that. We do have Jesse out on the streets right now, though. Let's see how his drive's going.
Well, good morning, Terry, and good morning to the rest of you. Yeah, Henderson Highway and Chief Peguis is going very well right now. So is McPhillips southbound and northbound. But I can tell you, as the hours go on this morning, it's going to get a little congested because southbound on McPhillips between Selkirk and Jarvis, there's going to be the curb lane closure. You see hydro crews on the scene right now. They're going to be drilling for poles, so you're going to lose a lane there. So as the hours creep on to 9 o'clock, traffic's going to be a little more congested here. Back to you, though, Eleanor and Kris.
Thanks a lot, Jesse. Jesse will be back in just 9 minutes. Well, I got to ask you, do you remember Charlie Brown's Great Pumpkin?
I do. Who doesn't? And these have nothing on the Great Pumpkin. These pumpkins that we're about to show you are monsters. Growers were hoping to bake records in Utah at the annual giant pumpkin weigh-in.
Yeah, they were huge, these pumpkins. I mean, some of them were over 1,000 pounds. Farmers from across the state, there you go, there you get to see some of the pumpkins, brought in their record-breaking pumpkins. And look at those things, just humongous. Surprisingly, most of the growers say the best part of this contest is finding ways to use the pumpkins once it's all over. So what do? You make a lot of pie?
Oh my goodness, what would you do? A sled for winter?
Look, they're even different colors. So are those green ones unripe?
I don't know. Yeah, I'm assuming so, because usually they get, you know, orange. The last year's record was more than 1,100 pounds.
Yeah.
It doesn't say. I don't know what the biggest one ended up being.
Yeah, they didn't say, but the secret to growing these big pumpkins, most of the farmers say a good seed, good soil, and of course, hard work.
Imagine that would be one big pumpkin pie.
Yeah, just trying to move that thing, you need a forklift.
They miss the little tender loving care.
Yes.
To grow them.
So Kristen Hirsch is joining us at the web desk. And Kristen, guess what? We got one of our first emails from Rob Anzi.
All right.
Nice to see a Winnipeg AM show. Great to have so many pretty ladies to wake up to.
Oh, Rob.
That's you, Kristen Hirsch.
Oh, Eleanor. Where's that Terry?
Well, thanks for pumping up the tires around here, Rob. They really needed that.
Pumping up my heels.
Thanks,
I think my high heels just grew 2 inches. Just pumping. Thank you, Rob.
Yeah, thanks, Rob.
All right, Kristen, what's going on?
Well, we also
board?
Have comments coming in on our Facebook page, so let's quickly take a look at that. Here it is. I showed you earlier this morning our Facebook page. Look at these two lovely hosts. Before I show you the comments, I'm going to show you our our likes right here because Eleanor's not very impressed. She didn't think that that was enough. Eleanor?
Well, come on, people.
She was disappointed in us. So maybe come on and like us at CTV Morning Live Winnipeg. There's
like
the name.
Us, like
and I just
us.
Want to give a shout out to Ray because we put a question out this morning saying our special guest today is Winnipeg Jet Eric Fair. What should we ask him?
Yeah.
And Ray said he would like to know if the team's performance during the preseason is what he expected. So we'll have to ask there Eric that.
Oh, that's interesting.
Among
that's a
other
question.
Things. Yeah. Now moving on, I get to talk about what was trending the night before. This was trending across Canada and in fact in Winnipeg. Pan Am, the show, premiered last night on CTV. I'm not doing any kind of shameless promotion. It really did trend last night,
yes.
I promise you.
I didn't get to see it, so I've taped it. So
well, this is the problem.
It.
You guys, we all go to bed.
We
go to bed like toddlers, so I can't talk about the show the next day because I don't want to ruin it for you.
My toddler goes to bed after me.
Oh,
actually,
Eleanor.
For the 2.5 years old and already beating you.
I know.
Do you know what? Overall, the reviews for the show sounded really great.
Oh, good.
Everyone liked it. It kind of has that Mad Men feel. You get to look at the old cars. And one of my favorite comments right here, the most striking thing about the whole show was that airplanes used to have leg room. Can you believe it?
And food.
That's
yeah.
right.
So it's fun to watch all of those things we don't have anymore.
Aww.
You also had to dress up to go on a plane, though. So
That's true. People
yeah, no one is wrapping
up.
Those pillows around their necks.
No.
That's right. Well, thanks a lot, Kristen.
You're welcome.
We'll be checking with Kristen throughout the morning. Yeah, no sweatpants on planes back
no,
in the 60s.
No, not back then. Well, your news is up next.
And then at 7:08, a CFL first. It happened on this day back in 2010. Bo, Tom, and Fraser from Fab 94 will be here to explain.
CTV Morning Live with Terry Apostle, weekday mornings from 6 to 9.
Winnipeg's favorite radio contest just got bigger. The $50,000 Beat Bob's Bank. You could win up to $50,000 tomorrow morning at 7:40 and 8:40 on 99.9 Bob FM. Can you beat Bob's Bank?
Monday on Consumer Watch.
More Canadians are finding bargain real estate in the U.S. Consumer Watch's Karen Rosnick explores what you need to know to ensure your deal doesn't go south.
Consumer Watch, Monday on CTV News.
Remember this, Mr. Selinger? 12 years ago, you asked for my vote and gave me this brochure. Let's review. You didn't end hallway medicine. Tuition fees are higher. Stats Can named us the violent crime capital of Canada again. The budget isn't balanced, and we have the highest taxes west of Quebec. I kept my card, just like you asked. Why didn't you keep your commitments?
We've talked about some things in the past. Now we have to get them done.
You've had 12 years to get things done. This time, I'm voting for vision, change, and progress.
Authorized by the CFO for PC Manitoba.
The all-new 2012 Kias have arrived, with a factory-authorized $500 cash bonus. Like the Sorento, the Soul, and the Sportage. Plus, the new Rondo and Forte are on their way. All with award-winning design, Bluetooth, hands-free, USB, and a 5-year warranty. But they won't last for long. When something this big happens, word travels fast. Hurry into your local dealer or visit Kia.ca today.
Got a lot on your plate at Thanksgiving, which is why Safeway has everything you need to get it all done. Right now, you can get a grade A frozen turkey under 7 kilograms for just 99 cents a pound. That's our promise. That's ingredients for life. Safeway.
In the 1990s, Manitoba's healthcare system was in trouble. 1,000 nurses were laid off. Millions of dollars were spent on American consultants, leading to service privatization and other questionable decisions. It became difficult for healthcare providers to properly care for their patients. When it comes to healthcare, it's about people. This October, make Manitoba Healthcare your issue one. A message from your Manitoba healthcare providers.
Somebody's gonna lift you up tonight. Gonna make you feel right. Fly.
You're wide awake tonight. It's so right.
Good morning. It's 7 o'clock. Thank you for joining us for our first ever CTV Morning Live. And keep all of your comments coming, Manitoba. We appreciate them, and we are looking for them. Lots to come up on the show today. We've got news and traffic and weather every 10 minutes with Terry Apostle.
We're also going to check in on the web desk with Kris throughout the morning. CTVWinnipeg.ca, an integral part of our news operation here, and she'll keep us on top of everything that's going on there. But first, we're going to check on today's headlines.
Ivan Radakaj was found dead 4 years ago. Today, those accused of his murder head to trial.
19 people are dead after the plane carrying them to see the world's highest peak crashes in Nepal.
Plus, finding Fido, a new tool to help reunite lost dogs with their owners. We'll have the details on that. Oh, what a sweetie. Coming up shortly.
It's 7:01. That means it's time to check in at the Weather Center. Terry's up on the roof, and I can't see your breast, so that means it's not 0 degrees.
You know, it's there. It's thin right now. Just a little bit of condensation for sure. The sun is coming up, though. It's looking gorgeous out here already. And it is going to be an incredible day. At the moment, it is 9 degrees here in Winnipeg. Just a bit of a wind from the south at 17 kilometers an hour. The humidity at the moment sitting at 93%. Now, 9 degrees here in Winnipeg, and it's looking good right across the board. In fact, there are places in northern Manitoba, just to the north of us, where you're waking up to an incredible morning. Look at that, 17 degrees still in Dauphin right now, 14 for the Pod, 12 in Thompson, 7 right now in Churchill. So a very mild morning across the board, and we'll all see those temperatures climb above normal for this time of year. We're expecting a high today in Winnipeg of 22 degrees, lots of sunshine, so not a bad day, and in fact, not a bad week. We've got sunshine expected for the rest of the week and above normal temperatures to carry us through. So great first week of fall, our official first full week of fall. On our drive this morning, you can see traffic is just beginning to pick up, but we do unfortunately have a problem. This is St. Mary Avenue at Fort Street, right in the downtown area. We've got a stalled garbage truck. Be on the lookout for it. Traffic is still fairly light in the area. It's not causing a huge delay. Just caution if you are in that area. But taking a look outside, you can see it is very, very nice. And we've got Jesse cruising the streets, so let's see how his drive's going.
Well, good morning, Terry. Good morning to all of you. Thanks for joining me live with the dash cam here. I'm going southbound on Phillips between Selkirk and Jarvis. Now, things are open when it comes to three lanes of traffic. Hydro crews are on standby here because there's going to be some drilling going on sometime this morning. That's going to cut down your curb lane. So if that's your travel southbound on McPhillips, you're going to only have two lanes compared to three lanes. Now, if you see any crashes or stalls you'd like to tell us about, send us a Twitter update at CTV Morning WPG. That's it for now from the road. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Jesse. It's 7:03. Let's take a look at the headlines. A trial is slated to start today into the killing of an Interlake man murdered back in 2007. 43-year-old Ivan Radakaj was found murdered in his home near Inwood in September 2007. RCMP say he died of blunt force trauma. A total of six people were charged in his death, including Radakaj's ex-wife, who was charged with conspiracy to commit murder. CTV Stacey Ashley will be at the courthouse today. We'll have more on that trial later on CTV News.
Winnipeg police are not releasing much information on the city's latest homicide. Just before 4:30 yesterday morning, a man was found dead in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor Streets. Police blocked off the streets and set up a white tent for several hours. Neighbors in the area said that they heard gunshots, but police won't confirm how the man died. There is no word on the victim's name. Anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers.
It's a parent's worst nightmare. Your child suddenly develop strange shakes and other symptoms, but doctors don't know what's wrong. That's what more than 20 Canadian families are facing with a recently discovered rare disease. A warning first, some viewers may find the images in this story disturbing.
Who is it?
That was 3-year-old Jaden before he started acting strangely, developing an odd walk, twitching, and other frightening symptoms that left her parents baffled. It wasn't until her spinal fluids were sent to a Pennsylvania researcher that they learned the cause of their problem, a brand new disease called anti-NMDAR, encephalitis. It's caused the body to attack the brain, but because it was just discovered 4 years ago, it's often misdiagnosed. Doctors say it can be treated with drugs, and 75% of victims recover. A year after treatment, Jaden is now perfectly normal.
A trip to see the highest mountain in the world has ended tragically in Nepal. Yesterday, a plane carrying 19 people crashed in dense fog while approaching Kathmandu, killing everyone on board. 16 of the passengers were tourists. The aircraft went down as it was returning from a viewing of Mount Everest and other Himalayan peaks. An eyewitness says the plane hit the roof of a house in a village and broke into several pieces.
An influential activist and the first African woman to be awarded the Nobel Peace Prize has died. Environmentalist Wangari Maathai passed away at a Nairobi hospital after a prolonged battle with cancer. She was one of the most recognizable women in her native Kenya and known for founding the Greenbelt Movement 30 years ago. The organization supported the planting of 40 million trees across the continent, a feat that won her the Nobel Prize in 2004. Maathai also served as a politician for several years. She was 71.
Well, a group of Winnipeg volunteers are trying something new to help families reunite with their lost dogs. It's a Facebook page called Winnipeg Lost Dog Alert. As soon as a dog is reported missing on the site, a picture, description, and where the dog was last seen is sent out to a network of people. The beauty of Facebook. The volunteers then start searching for the lost pet. The group says they've found 50 lost dogs since the beginning of the year.
That's a fabulous story.
That's great. It's great. A good idea.
Yeah, you don't want to lose a dog, and if you do, I mean, it's traumatic, and to help out is great.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, it's 7:06, time now to hit the streets again and check in with Rochelle Legacy. The kids have been in school for about a month now, and this morning you're talking about school zone safety.
That's right, Kris. I'm standing here at Heritage Elementary School in St. James, and this is where kids get dropped off or picked up at the end of the school day. And CAA Manitoba wanted to see what drivers were doing in school zones. So they parked in three different school zones around Winnipeg and started recording what sort of behavior drivers were doing in that 1 hour of time. And you wouldn't even believe it. They recorded 535 infractions altogether. And some of the stuff drivers were doing is really unbelievable. A man was shaving, a woman was waxing her eyebrows. I wouldn't even put lipstick on without stopping the car, but some of these drivers were doing all kinds of crazy and, frankly, dangerous behavior. And so coming up a little later, I'll talk more with CAA Manitoba about the study and what they hope to do with that information.
Thanks, Rochelle. We've actually got Kristen putting on our webpage asking people what they've seen, so we might hear some more disturbing stories of bad behavior.
Hopefully drivers fess up.
It's amazing what people try to get away with in the car. Thanks a lot, Rochelle. Well, it's coming up to 7:08. A legendary actor passes away.
It's one of many events that happened on this day. Here's Bo, Tom, and Fraser from Fab 94 FM.
Good morning. Isn't there some kind of a law that by this time in September you're not allowed to wear shorts?
I suppose there is. I have no long pants.
Tom can't read. He never got the memo.
At my disposal. I'll get some next time.
Let's pass one, Fraser. But let's have a look at some stuff going on here. Monday, September 26th, Johnny Appleseed was born in 1774.
He was a busy, busy man. Right now in the world today, 7,500 different types of apples. He's been busy spreading his seeds.
This is a little known. He was the first guy to be charged with littering.
Oh, really?
You can't just go tossing out the apple seeds and apple cores.
I can't go a day without a Granny Smith.
I know. We hear you every morning.
Very tart.
And an apple.
That too, yeah. Hey, listen, the guy from E.T. was born on this day, T.S. Eliot.
No, he's an author and a poet. And as a matter of fact, when you go to see the Broadway play Cats, you can thank T.S. Eliot for
memories.
Enough.
That's all I know.
Speaking of memories, just on a sad note, in 2008, after a long battle with cancer, Paul Newman passed away on this day.
What a great, great man. Oh, boy, he was so gorgeous. Those blue eyes. Oh, they just went on forever.
A cool hand, Luke.
Yes.
Great films. He won the Oscar finally after being nominated, I think, six times for The Color of Money in 1986.
Oh, Cat in a Hot Tin Roof, still one of his best movies ever.
Well, his movies were good, but his salad dressing even better. All right? Love it. All right, what else? Oh, you know what? We just had a game in Moncton this past weekend, the Stamps and the Tiger Cats. In 2010, the CFL played its first ever game in Atlantic Canada. It was between the Eskimos and the Argos.
Will they ever get a team there?
I'd like to see a team there, but I don't know.
All right.
How's that for a story?
Yeah. Thank you.
Hey, the Jets are back in town, but
yay.
I'm talking about the Jets and the Sharks. West Side Story in 1957 debuted on Broadway.
Why is it the guys really like West Side Story? I don't understand it, because it's dancing with fake knives?
It's named the Jets.
The Jets.
I guess that's it, right?
Hey, Abbey Road, one of your favorite albums from the Beatles, came out this day, 1969.
Not the last released Beatles album, but the last recorded Beatles album.
She came in through the bathroom window. Always good. Always my favorite.
Yeah.
And last but not least, on a sad note again, Robert Palmer. Who can forget his videos? Passed away on this day in 2003. Apparently, he was addicted to love.
Yes,
apparently
he was.
And so am I. Yeah. And that's it for On This Day, September 26th.
Robert Palmer, some of the great songs of the 80s.
I didn't know.
Now we know.
Now I know, yeah.
Well, eight years ago he passed away.
I know. Where was I? Under a rock, apparently.
You must have missed that.
Kristen Hirsch is joining us now from the web desk. And do you have some comments or people writing in telling us what's up?
We do. We have comments coming in. We have comments for our guest later, our Winnipeg Jet guest, inaugural guest, Eric Fair.
Right.
We're going to ask him some questions. But right now I want to ask Winnipeg a question, because earlier this morning I said, you know what, Manitoba, I want to have you as my co-host, because Elanor gets to have Kris, so I want to have the whole city. I'm selfish like that. Here's our Twitter page. Our handle is CTV Morning WPG if you want to follow us on Twitter. And I put the question out there. Rochelle Legacy is out on location talking while learning about school zone safety. What is the most ridiculous thing you've seen drivers doing? So we want to hear from you. What have you seen drivers doing out on the road? Raising awareness, maybe we can call some people out so they won't do it anymore.
All right,
sounds
thanks a lot,
good.
Kristen. So far we have waxing eyebrows and shaving.
Yeah,
so
try and top that.
I'm sure we'll get some more.
All right, 11 minutes past the hour, time now to check in with Terry. And Terry, are we in for another great day today?
Kris, we are. In fact, we're in for another great week. It's looking incredible
good.
For today and right through into the weekend. So for those of you that hate Mondays and think, I can't wait for the weekend, well, it's going to be looking good too. So outside right now, it's 9 degrees. Winds from the south at 17 kilometers an hour. The humidity at 93%. You can see the sun is up now. Clear sky and a beautiful day in store for us. Taking a look at what we're expecting to get up to today, 22 degrees, lots of sunshine. Today, the winds will be from the south at 30 kilometers an hour. Now, overnight, we'll drop down to about 10. That's well above normal still for this time of year. Very clear, and the winds tapering off to about 15 kilometers an hour. Still from the south, and tomorrow those winds will shift from the west at 15 kilometers an hour. We'll get a high of 24 degrees, and once again, lots of sunshine in store for us. And in fact, our long-range forecast too is looking very good. Look at this: Wednesday, 23 degrees, and lots of sunshine. Thursday, we are going to see things cooling off ever so slightly as the high-pressure ridge that's above us right now begins to move to the east. But even still, as things cool down, we'll still be above normal for the rest of the week. Lots of sunshine. It's looking great.
Well, that looks like a great forecast. And Terry, you know, I had a great weekend. I was outdoors. You took part in something a little different.
I did. Now, I was outdoors for a lot of it, but then on Saturday afternoon, I headed down to the Assiniboine Downs, moved inside for a cat costume competition.
Nice.
The Prairie Feline Fanciers were there, and they were
But they used to be the Cat Association.
The Manitoba
right?
Cat Club, yes.
That's
and so they were
club.
There, and it was a big cat show. And, I mean, the cats are judged on you know, their breed, and it's like a real cat show until you get to the costume side of things.
I mean, I never try to judge a cat, but if you have to, I guess you might as well dress them up and see what they look like.
That's
Terry
right.
Has
I took some pictures. Take a look at this. This is Alice and the Cheshire Cat.
Oh, it's a smile. I thought it was some sort of...
Those are teeth.
Muzzle? No, that's not a muzzle. That's the smile on the cat. Isn't that hilarious? And there she is again, Alice and Cheshire Cat. So there were lots of great cats that were dressed up in costume. My son got a kick out of it and called it Cat Halloween.
Oh, who's that?
This one here dressed up like a tiger. And, you know, some of the cats, understandably so, didn't necessarily like the get-ups they were in.
You think?
This particular cat loved it. He was so docile and just happy to be the little Tigger Teddy.
He owned it. He owned it. That's
he
good.
Really did.
Well, I used to live by a rule of never to dress up a cat, but I might have to change my views on that.
Oh, you now, know, you're missing out on some fun. I used to dress my cats up in doll's clothes all the time.
See, it's that type of cat, because CTV's Jill McEachon has that cat. You should see what her kids do to
with
that
the
cat.
Little pushed-in
oh,
face.
My goodness. They are so docile. They'll let anybody do anything to them.
All right, Terry. Well, thanks a lot for that cat dressing up update. We'll check in with you again for weather in a few minutes. All right, coming up in about 10 minutes, your chance to win tickets to Avril Lavigne's show at the MTS Center next month.
And police investigate Winnipeg's 32nd homicide after a grisly discovery in the North End.
CTV Morning Live with Elanor Coopsammy, Kris Laudien, and Terry Apostle. Throughout the seasons, Manitobans experience dramatic weather systems and patterns. From a colorful prairie sky to a remarkable storm to a devastating flood. Email your best weather shots to winnipegweather@ctv.ca. Watch CTV News at noon and 6 to see if your photo is the featured Skywatch pick of the day. And go to our website for a look back at weather photos from the past year. The Skywatch pick of the day. Brought to you by Case Financial Group. Apply online for the best rate mortgage.
Ashley Furniture Home Store's big event is almost over. Get hundreds of groups less than $50 a month with interest-free financing for 36 months, plus big savings throughout the entire store. It's the final days of the big event at Ashley Furniture Home Store.
2011 was an amazing year for Chevrolet. Come see why during our model year wrap-up. In 2011, our globally proven Cruze became the AJAC Canadian Car of the Year. The legendary Silverado was named Motor Trend Truck of the Year. And fuel efficiency had to be best in class. Get 0% financing on most 2011s, plus up to $10,000 in cash credits on select models. The model year wrap-up at your Chevrolet dealer now.
Back pain, sometimes it was a problem. It can be frustrating. Luckily, I discovered Tylenol Back Pain. It has a muscle relaxant, plus the trusted pain relief of Tylenol.
Tylenol Back Pain. Get back to normal, whatever your normal is.
Body pain. There's no doubt that snacking can be a part of a healthy lifestyle. And with the right snacks, you can keep your energy up throughout the day.
The challenge is to decide which foods to snack on and how much.
Fruit packed in fruit juice with no preservatives or artificial sweeteners is a quick, no fuss, and nutritious option. It's easy to pack for a school or work lunch, and fruit has a natural sweetness while replenishing your energy and providing a variety of vitamins, minerals, and antioxidants. It's also a healthy option when you're on the go. And evenings can be a tempting time to indulge on the wrong snacks. So by keeping prepared fruit on hand, your family is more likely to have more servings of fruit each day.
Snacking doesn't have to add empty excess calories to your diet. If you choose wisely, the right snacks can help you improve your eating habits.
So when you snack, make it a healthy option. Until next time, keep fit and have fun.
Body Break.
Color that fades and washes out? Not an option. For my color, I trust expert care.
Discover new color radiance from L'Oreal. Enriched with sun filters, conditioning formula nourishes and protects hair to better lock in color.
Deep nourishment, stay true, radiant color. This divine blonde, I love it. It's protected for up to 7 weeks.
88% agree hair is soft and shiny. New color radiance from L'Oreal. Recommended by the number one in hair color.
We're worth it.
Good morning. It's 8 degrees at 7:18, a shot of Provence Bridge as you get ready for the Monday morning rush. You're watching CTV Morning Live. Police are investigating the city's 32nd homicide of the year. A man was found dead just before 4:30 yesterday morning in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor Streets. Police blocked off the street and set up a white tent for several hours as a homicide and identification units, along with the medical examiner, were on scene. Neighbors say they heard gunshots, but police won't confirm how the man died.
A passerby who had walked by and stated that there was an injured male at this location. We did get there. Our officers did arrive on scene and located an adult male who was, in fact, deceased.
Police say the investigation is in its early stages and won't say if it's gang-related. There is no word on the victim's name or how he died. Anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers. A gruesome discovery along the banks of the Red River this weekend. Yesterday afternoon, a body was found in the water. Right now, police aren't giving any details about the gender or age of the person. We do know emergency crews were called out to the 2100 block of Henderson Highway near Knowles Avenue just before 2. Details are still emerging. Police won't say if it's connected to the drowning of 6-year-old Nathaniel Thorassi. He disappeared beneath the ice back in December. His body hasn't been found. The Winnipeg Police Service Underwater Search and Recovery Unit is part of the investigation, which is continuing. A tragic story is emerging from Quebec. Two men and one woman died trying to save their children from drowning. It happened in Quebec's Saguenay region. The boys, aged 6 and 8, waded too far into the river and got into trouble. The boy's father went into the river to try to rescue the older boy, who was safely returned to shore. When the man went back into the for the other child, the mother also joined them. That boy was pulled to shore, but the three adults disappeared into the river. The woman was found unconscious on the bank and died a short time later. The men's bodies were recovered yesterday morning. trying to swim from Cuba to Florida has left its mark on an American endurance athlete, Diana Nayad. A whole collection of marks, actually, inflicted by Portuguese man-o-war jellyfish. After 40 hours in the water and more than 100,000 swim strokes, the 62-year-old called off the attempt. It was her second try in as many months. Medical members on her team said one more toxic sting could be life-threatening. Nayad wanted to be the first to make the swim without the protection of a shark cage. So great effort, but
that's too bad.
Those jellyfish, those are huge jellyfish. I've been stung by a little jellyfish and that stings.
I
can't imagine
that hurts.
What that would be like. And 62, good for her.
Well, it's time now for Choose Your News, and this is where Kristen will give you options of the day, and then you tell us what you want to see, right, Kristen?
That's right, and it's also my favorite part of the day.
Yes.
It's ours, it
and I know it's yours, too, both of you.
It
I
is.
Know it. So it's Choose Your News. This is when I feel like a game show host or something, but I'm going to give you three options. Throw it out to the city. You're going to log on to our website, click on Morning Show, and tell me what you want. The first one is Star Wars Legoland, if you want the Force to be with you this morning. Number two is laughing yoga. Maybe you want to start your day with a big belly Buddha laugh, Kris. What do you think?
I like it. I'll laugh it up.
And number three is tiger dress up. No, it's not Halloween, but it's the perfect start to your morning. So log on to our website, click on our Morning Show link, and you will find the poll there. Vote, and in 15 minutes, I will report on whatever wins. So if you want something, you need to vote, or it may not win.
Sounds good.
Vote, Winnipeg.
Sounds good, Kristen. You want to get on your computers and email Kristen, and we'll show you that in a few minutes.
Perfect.
Right now it's 7:21. Time to get to weather with Terry Apostle. Terry, it was a beautiful weekend. No ice on the windshield this morning. I think it's going to be another warm day.
Hope it stays that way.
You guys are absolutely right. A gorgeous weekend for our first official weekend of fall, and for our first official full week of fall, it's looking good too. Take a look at our current conditions. 8 degrees right now in Winnipeg. We have dropped just slightly. It'll climb again, don't you worry. Still 8 in Portage, Brandon, 8 for Fisher Branch, 17 still in Dauphin, though looking very, very good. And across northern Manitoba, look at that. Temperatures well above normal. A gorgeous morning that you're waking up to. On our satellite, you can see that there's just a little bit of cloud coverage right now, but even over Winnipeg, Winnipeg is in the clear and is going to stay in the clear. That cloud coverage will pass just to the north of us, right across the lake there. So we really will be seeing plenty of sunshine right across Manitoba for the next couple of days, with a little bit of cloud creeping in there every now and then. But for the most part, looking good with temperatures well above normal for this time of year. You can see that here in our long-range forecast, showing you that we'll get up to 22 for today, 24 for Tuesday. It'll stay above normal for the rest of the week, right into the weekend, and lots of sunshine in store for us too. So the forecast is just looking phenomenal. Our drive this morning, we do have one issue that you'll spot. It's a stalled garbage truck, and it's right here. Whoops, I'll spin around here. St. Mary Avenue at Fort. So a stalled garbage truck right now. Traffic's still very light in the area. Not a major problem, but we've also got Jesse out on the streets cruising around. Let's see how his drive is going. Jesse, how's the dash?
Well, good morning, Terry, and good morning to all of you. Here I am on Wall Street right by TechVoc High School, home of the Hornets, and traffic flowing pretty nicely, as you can see right in front of me. Now, you have three lanes of traffic. Recently, it's just been two lanes because of city crews working on the road here. Right now, it's three, but I just talked to a city official. He's moving the signs a little bit farther south on Wall Street, and it will continue to be two lanes of traffic. Don't know when he's going to move those signs. Also, just want to tell you, Highway 59 south of Birds Hill, at the railroad crossing, lights are flashing, no train. Avoid that area if you can. That's it for now. Back to you, though.
That's our man on the street, Jesse Carlson. He'll be keeping you updated on the rush all morning long. Well, it's coming up to 7:24. Time for a contest.
Yay.
Every Monday here at CTV Morning Live, we'll be doing what we call our last chance giveaway. One last chance to win on a contest we had last week on CTV News at noon or 6.
Our very first last chance giveaway this week is tickets to Avril Lavigne's upcoming concert at the MTS Center on October 14th.
To win, email us the answer to this trivia question. Here it is. What was the name of Avril Lavigne's six-time platinum debut album?
Send us the correct answer with the subject line Avril, along with your first and last name, email address, and phone number to winnipegcontest@ctv.ca. We'll name the winner later in the show. And if you forget all of this, you can always go to our website and we'll have all those details there too if you forget.
That's right, ctvwinnipeg.ca. That's where you can find a link to our website for that. Great prize to give away.
Oh, it's an awesome prize. So I'm sure we'll get a lot of response on that.
Definitely. Well, coming up, Rochelle Legacy, she's out and about talking about school zone safety.
Yeah, that's right. She's on in St. James at Heritage Park School, and she's speaking with CAA's Liz Peters. We'll have her in just a moment.
SkyWatch weather brought to you by Nisbe Home Renovations. It pays to go with a name you know. Breaking news sent straight to your cell phone or email.
So when you buy this range and dishwasher, you get this beautiful 18 cubic foot Frigidaire fridge for just $199.
High five. Down low. Robot handshake. Yeah. Saw the tree. Desk bump.
Oh, no, I'm not comfortable.
Magic fingers. Magic fingers. Freeze frame high five.
This week, Leon's is shaking things up with its all-new Spectacular Prices event, where you'll find the lowest appliance and TV prices you've ever seen. And you don't have to pay for 18 months. Don't miss it.
Manitoba Hydro, it's our oil, it's our future, and it's at risk. Why? Because Hugh McFadden is a privatizer. He admits he played a central role when the PCs broke their promise and privatized MTS. He worked to privatize Ontario Hydro. Now Hugh McFadden says he'll open Manitoba Hydro to private investors. If Hugh McFadden gets the chance, he'll privatize Manitoba Hydro. Our rates will go up, and we'll never get it back. Hugh McFadden and Manitoba Hydro, too big a risk.
Hey, Glenn, you want a cigarette? Come on, you know you want one.
When quitting gets tough, great-tasting Nicorette Extreme Chill Gum can help you stay on track. For every cigarette, there's a Nicorette.
Talking a big game about your engine is one thing. The Cummins Turbo Diesel has a proven history in the real world. Unsurpassed torque, best-in-class towing, Canada's best-selling diesel pickup. Which engine do you want powering your truck?
Right now, get a new 2011 Ram Heavy Duty with a no-charge Cummins Turbo Diesel.
Guts. Glory. Ram.
CTV Tonight.
I know you can handle it. Come on, go for it, Dancertron.
They're a force to be reckoned with.
You know I love a bad girl.
Oh, it gets down and dirty.
The most talked about dancing cast ever.
I couldn't stop crying.
We'll have you talking even more.
I want more and more and more dancing.
Dancing is back with a vengeance.
Bam!
All new Dancing with the Stars. Tonight at 8, 7 Central on CTV.
Closed captioning is brought to you in part by Pronamel. Helps protect your tooth enamel against the acid wear your morning orange juice can cause.
Well, just a few more minutes left for you to vote for the winner of Choose Your News.
Yeah, good options today. Number one, Star Wars Legoland. I can only imagine what they're building there. Two, laughing yoga. I always laugh when I do yoga. And three, tiger dress up.
Other people laugh when you do yoga too. To vote, log on to our website at ctvwinnipeg.ca and click on the CTV Morning Live link.
It's 7:28, time to check in with Rochelle Legacy. She's on location talking about school zone safety. How are things going down there this morning, Rochelle?
Great. Actually, drivers are slowly coming in, so we're keeping an eye on their driving behavior. I'm joined with by Liz Peters here. She's with CAA Manitoba. Liz, give us some tips on how to drive safely, because this is a crosswalk we're looking at here. So what should drivers do in this area?
Yeah, definitely one of the things that happened during our school zone assessment, not only at crosswalks like this, but also at stop lines, when you're waiting at a red light, the solid white line on either side, when your car is stopped, you should be able to see the entire crosswalk. So if you can't see the first white line or the side white line, it means you're up too close. Same goes for at a red light when there's a stop line. If you can't see that entire stop line in front of your car, then you've gone too far. And if there was a pedestrian crossing in that corridor when you pulled over, you could potentially hit them.
Now, no stopping zones are also important in school zones, aren't they?
Yeah, definitely. And most schools have certain regulations and specifications as when you're allowed to park and when you're not to. In this school zone in particular, because it's a residential area, they have no stopping from 8 until 5 p.m. So it's normally 9 to 5 when you see that kind of thing, but they've made it earlier because they know that school starts here at 8:30. So if people are pulling up and stopping there, they're going to cause challenges. Pedestrians sometimes cut in between cars. If there's a bus at that time, then kids can be getting off. And if you're stopped there, that's going to cause it's going to cause some risk in the school zone. So the no stopping is another really big infraction.
Okay, so there are a few things, do's and don'ts. Give me two don'ts that you shouldn't do.
Oh.
We're running out of time here, unfortunately.
Well, I mean, we already talked about the don't stop and stop zones, but not rolling through the stop signs. That's another thing we do when we think no one's looking. It's definitely very dangerous. And then don't ignore the school safety patrols. Sometimes older kids might be crossing the street as well, and there might be the kids, which they're in grade six, and they've got their flag and their vest out. And a lot of people from time to time might just cross beside them. They think they're not responsible to use the school crossing guards, but they're there for whatever.
And we'll talk to some of those patrollers later on in the show.
Good morning. Welcome to CTV Morning Live, our inaugural show. We're excited in here. We hope you're as excited as we are. We're going to introduce you to the whole team throughout the morning. We have Terry Apostle in the Weather Center. We check in with her every 10 minutes. Jesse Carlson out on the street. He's our man in traffic, and he'll keep us up to date on the morning rush.
And as you saw, CTV's Rochelle Legacy is at Heritage Park School talking about school safety today. So we'll check back in with her throughout the morning. And we also have Kristen Hirsch at our web desk bringing us all your comments and checking on online, what's going on and what's hot in Twitter.
That's right, but first let's take a look at what's making news in Winnipeg.
On the campaign trail, what's Manitoba's political leaders are up to today?
An American man charged after a Montreal woman's body found encased in concrete.
And getting the last laugh, the celebrity who's hosted Saturday Night Live more than anyone else. We'll have all that coming up shortly.
That's a great pair, Steve Martin and Alec Baldwin.
I know, no love them.
Funny guys. Good morning, Terry.
How are you, Terry?
Hey, good. I'm excited. We've got such a gorgeous day ahead of us, and apparently, according to Steve Martin there, there's going to be some laughs coming your way as well. But we're waking up. It's a beautiful morning. The sun is up now and shining. 8 degrees currently. Winds from the south at 15 kilometers an hour. And the humidity at the moment, 95%. Downtown is beginning to come alive, enjoying the beautiful morning. And in fact, right across the province, we're waking up to above normal temperatures. It's 8 degrees right now in Portageton and Brandon, 17 in Dauphin. Just an incredible morning. Thompson, even 12 degrees at the moment. The Pas, 13. So very mild morning. And today in Winnipeg, at least, we're expecting to get up to 22 degrees. Lots of sunshine expected for us, and those above normal temperatures will last not just for today, right through the week into the weekend. So it is looking very, very good for not just today, as I mentioned, but the whole week ahead. Our first official full week of fall will be above normal. Nobody's going to be complaining about that at all. And our drive is looking pretty good as well. As I mentioned, downtown is certainly starting to come alive. You can see this is a shot of McPhillips at Notre Dame. Traffic is still fairly light in the area, just beginning to pick up. No major issues right now. It's all moving very well, and of course we've got Jesse also out on the streets cruising around. Jesse, how's your drive going?
Well, good morning, Terry. Things are going pretty smoothly right now, except the curb lane on McPhillips southbound between Selkirk and John Jarvis. The city has been pressing this closure for a while, and here it is. What is a Winnipeg morning without a new barricade? Now, you're going to lose that curb lane, again, from Selkirk to Jarvis, as hydro crews are drilling today for new hydro pools. Again, three lanes, so again, from lanes down to two, and as you can see on the right side of your TV screen, that is your delay this morning southbound on McPhillips. If you see any crashes and you are still like to let us know about it, drop us a tweet at CTV Morning WPG on your good old Twitter page. That's all I got for now. Back to you, though.
Thanks, Jesse. The time is 7:33. Provincial party leaders are busy today as the October 4th election approaches. NDP leader Greg Selinger will spend some time at the Winnipeg Indoor Soccer Complex before heading out to Fisher Branch for a healthcare announcement. Progressive Conservative leader Hugh McFadden will hit the doors in St. Vital after making an announcement of his own. Yesterday, the Liberals released some green initiatives. Liberal leader John Girard unveiled his eco-plan for the province. If elected, Girard would reduce phosphorus in Manitoba lakes, protect space for community gardens, and invest in green economy. In your home, Girard said he would also phase out phosphorus in dishwasher detergents and invest in a composting program. The plan would cost $4 million.
And a few hundred party faithful attended an NDP rally inside the Park Theatre yesterday afternoon. NDP leader Greg Selinger bolstered the crowd by outlining his election platform and took some jabs at PC leader Hugh McFadden. Meanwhile, McFadden attended Temple at the Sikh Society of Winnipeg yesterday morning. Later, he attended the Winnipeg Sun editorial board meeting.
Well, he was murdered 4 years ago, and now a trial is slated to start in the killing of Ivan Radokaj. The 43-year-old was found murdered in his home near Inwood in September 2007. RCMP say he died of blunt force trauma. A total of six people were charged in his death, including Radokaj's ex-wife, who was charged with conspiracy to commit murder. CTV's Stacey Ashley will be at the courthouse today, and she'll bring us more on the trial later on CTV News at Noon.
The mystery of a Montreal-born woman whose body was found encased in concrete has taken another turn. Yesterday, Randy Lara's American husband, Stephen Lacuna, was charged with murder. The arrest came one day after neighbors held a vigil outside the New Jersey apartment building where the victim lived with her husband and daughter. It's also where Lara's remains were found Friday, 6 weeks after Lacuna reported her missing. Her body will be returned to Montreal for a funeral.
A suicide bomb attack on a church in Indonesia has hurt at least 30 people. The church was packed with hundreds of worshipers when the bomb went off yesterday. It is not known who is behind the attack, which was heard half a mile away. But in the last 9 years, Indonesia has suffered a series of suicide bombings blamed on a network linked to Al-Qaeda.
Actor Alec Baldwin has edged out Steve Martin to break the record for hosting Saturday Night Live. And of course, the comedian made sure he got the last laugh.
Well, aren't we proud of ourselves?
Steve, what are you doing here?
Oh, I was just passing by the studio in full makeup. And I heard you were breaking my hosting record, and while I'm happy for you, I wanted to make sure that you were doing it without the use of steroids or performance-enhancing drugs.
It was Baldwin's 16th time hosting the show. He kicked off SNL's 37th season with special guests Seth Rogen and Radiohead. Couple of funny guys there.
That's awesome.
So yeah. Good.
Hi, Kristen.
Wait, hello. I have some results over here. Would you like to hear them?
I would love to hear that.
All right, earlier, well, about 20 minutes ago, I put out some options for Winnipeg to vote on. Choose your news. The options were, number one, Star Wars Legoland. This is the force will be with you. Number two, laughing yoga. And number three, tiger dress up. Well, the results are in, and the winner is laughing yoga.
Really?
By just one vote. Can you believe it? So there they are. Really, what's so funny? It's this big inside joke, or so it looks. But a group of health-conscious people have taken over a spot in Vietnam's capital to exercise a good laugh. They're releasing endorphins, as you know, is so good for you. And there's a lot of just different movements, and they're in charge of making each other laugh, too. So make your coworkers laugh today as well.
Look at that guy.
Well, apparently, if Kris does yoga, we'll all laugh.
So, laughter yoga started in India, so it originated in India. And I'm really going to look and hope for there's a class in Winnipeg to do this.
Oh, you have to take a camera with you then, Kristen, if you do that.
Well, maybe we need to start a class. I know that Nancy Carlson, she's a little yogi, so maybe we can convince her to teach it.
Oh, that's awesome.
Now, if your story wasn't chosen, you can. I don't want to make anyone unhappy. So you can log on to our website, ctvwinnipeg.ca, click on Morning Show, and I'm going to put all the videos up in about 1 minute. I'm going to do it right now.
All right.
Sounds good,
okay.
Kristen. Thanks.
Sounds good. Lots to laugh about in Vietnam.
Yeah, apparently.
It's 8 degrees outside right now. Your weather, news, and traffic is next on CTV Morning Live.
Monday on Consumer Watch.
More Canadians are finding bargain real estate in the U.S. Consumer Watch's Karen Rosnick explores what you need to know to ensure your deal doesn't go south.
Consumer Watch, Monday on CTV News.
So we also laid out a full-size model of the ridge for the men to practice on. They know where every German strong point is, every machine gun, every bunker.
General Hurry, you do know the French have tried for the last year to take Vimy Ridge, yes? And that we also...
I know, sir.
What exactly makes you...
Our guns will begin at dawn.
My dear wife, this may be my last letter to you. We go into action in 20 minutes. It's the biggest thing I've ever been in.
At precisely 0500, the men will move out of the tunnels, keeping precisely 300 yards behind the creeping barrage.
Dear Mother, as I looked to right and left, all I could see was Canadians.
By 5 o'clock, Vimy Ridge was ours.
And Mother, I thought, we are a nation. This is us.
It was the first significant victory of the war.
Reinventing the vacuum cleaner has been an obsession of mine for the past 17 years. It began with cyclone technology. For me, the fundamental answer to loss of suction. Next, we eliminated bags. Then came our ball, a radical alternative to fixed wheels. Our mission is simple. Solve the obvious problems others seem to ignore.
The joy of childhood, at any age, for you, for her. For generations, Wonder Bread has been your favorite. And now, it's free of artificial preservatives, free of artificial colors, free of artificial flavors. What other bread makes you feel this free? New Wonder Bread, the same fresh taste you love. Baked fresh daily. For joyful nutrition.
Design, incredible flexibility, and self-storing leaves, Dufresne's exclusive expandables dining table is perfect for whatever you can think of. Dufresne, a better experience for 25 years.
Weather updates sent straight to your cell phone or email. Skywatch Weather Wake Up. Sign up now at ctvwinnipeg.ca. Breaking news sent directly to your cell phone or email. CTV Breaking News Alert. Sign up now at ctvwinnipeg.ca. If you catch the news as it happens, we want the world to see it. Send it to our website. Click on My News, and we'll put it online. Your pictures, your video, My News.
You're watching CTV Morning Live, and a shot of the Disraeli Freeway. Traffic is picking up. It is 7:41.
A little bit of a rush here, southbound.
Yeah.
Yes. It is time for that, but right now it's 7:41. We're going to check into the Weather Center with Terry Apostle. Beautiful morning out there. Is it going to continue throughout the day?
Yes, it is, Kris. Everybody that's up and at them already is dealing with lots of sunshine, and in fact, the sun is out all day. We'll be seeing plenty of it. 8 degrees currently, winds from the south at 15 kilometers an hour, and the humidity at 95%. And if you take a look at our satellite radar image right now, you can see nothing is showing up right now. Nothing but sunshine is in store for us, and that's why. So no precipitation and not even a lot of cloud coverage. It's looking very good. Here's a look at what we're expecting today for our high conditions, and you can see it's going to be above normal even to areas of the north. 19 degrees expected for Churchill, Gillam, Island Lake will get up to 20 in Thompson, 23 degrees with lots of sunshine, 25 in Lynn Lake, Flin Flon, The Paw, and Norway House, all seeing above normal temperatures for this time of year. And as we move a little bit further south, there's the sunshine that we're looking for. 25 degrees for Swan River, and Dauphin and Brandon both expecting 24 for today. Here in Winnipeg, we're hoping to get up to 22 degrees. Lots of sunshine. In fact, everyone around us will be seeing about 22 degrees. Barron's River, just a little bit lower than that at 21. And in Ontario, it is also looking good with lots of sunshine and temperatures above normal for this time of year. Our long-range forecast, too, looks very good. 22 expected for today, 24 for tomorrow, 23 for Wednesday. Just incredible weather for the start of this week. It will cool down slightly for Thursday in the latter part of the week as the high-pressure ridge that's above us begins to make its way eastward. But still, 17 degrees for Thursday is above normal for this time of year. The forecast looks incredible. Our drive this morning is beginning to pick up. You can certainly see it. We are keeping our eye on this stretch of McPhillips between Selkirk and Jarvis. Southbound traffic is dealing with a lane closure in the area. So traffic is down to two lanes. It's the right-hand curb lane that you lose. We've also got Jesse out on the streets cruising around. Jesse, how are things looking?
Well, good morning, Terry. The sun is starting to shine, as you can see right in my face. Well, the sun is shining on all these motorists here going southbound on Main Street. This is, of course, as you approach Higgins, you lose that curb lane. We've been dealing with this for a couple months now, and motorists are dealing with it this morning. But I can tell you some good news, though. St. Mary's and Fort, that garbage truck is now gone, so traffic flowing there nicely. Drop us a tweet at CTV Morning WPG if you see any traffic tips out there. Back to you, though.
Thanks, Jesse. Well, it's time now to check back in with CTV's Rochelle Legace, and she is at Heritage Park School with CAA's Liz Peters.
That's right. And take a look at this, Eleanor. This is a color and a vest you should recognize. And distracted drivers should certainly keep an eye out for this vest, right, Liz?
Yeah.
Why is it so important for people to...
Well, I mean, when you see this kind of vest, it means there's someone working on the road. So it could be a construction worker, could be a paramedic, but it also could be a school safety patrol. So the orange vest with the reflective tape tells you
to watch out for somebody on the road.
Now, patrollers have been a part of Winnipeg and Manitoba for 75 years this year, right?
Yeah, for sure, since 1936. And in that year, Louise Staples, she was a teacher at Greenway School, because they're right down the street from the Minto Armories. They realized that with there was tanks going up and down the road, they needed some more safe ways for kids to get to school. So she had a group of students from the school start a school patrol program, and the rest is history.
There are how many patrollers? Do we know how many in Manitoba?
Yeah, in Manitoba, there's more than 10,000.
Wow.
Here in the city of Winnipeg, there is close to 7,000 patrols.
And so they work right here in a crosswalk exactly like this. So what should drivers keep in mind when they see kids and patrollers working in this area?
Yeah, when the patrols have somebody that they need to cross, they're going to take one step off the curb, and they're going to have a flag in their hands, and the kids they're going to use hand motions to signal the kids across the street. Now, until the patroller is completely back on the sidewalk and completely stepped back from the curb, it's your just duty as a motorist to not move. So, if you take a couple seconds early, if you start moving a couple seconds early, you could be putting those kids at risk.
So quickly, these are going to change color, aren't they?
Yeah, definitely. It's something that CAA and MPI have been working on together. We want to make sure that the vests are as safe as possible. And if you've noticed, there's a little bit more yellow-green, the fluorescent color, when you see construction zones and whatnot. So that's something that we're investigating, and you might see some changes coming forward in the next couple weeks.
Exciting changes. So drivers, if you're watching right now, keep an eye out for these vests. You want to keep our kids safe. And certainly, if you do see something like this, they're at work. So stay back behind those white lines and keep a safe distance until the kids are safely across the road. We'll have more tips for drivers coming up, and also we'll watch patrollers as they work away. They're about to start their job and their day today.
Great. Thanks a lot, Rochelle. Very interesting facts. It is 7:45. Winnipeg police are not yet saying much as they investigate the city's 32nd homicide. Just before 4:30 yesterday morning, a man was found dead in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor. Police blocked off the streets and set up a white tent for several hours. Now, neighbors in the area say they heard gunshots, but police wouldn't confirm exactly how the man died. There is no word yet on the victim's name. Anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers. What was a day to remember? Officers who lost their lives while protecting the lives of others. A bagpipe procession opened the police and peace officers' memorial service held at the Manitoba Legislature yesterday. It honors officers from a number of different services who were killed on the job. Winnipeg Police Chief Keith McCaskill read the names of the 8 Winnipeg police officers who lost their lives while on duty. Premier Greg Selinger commended all peace officers for putting their lives on the line.
So as we remember today those who have given that ultimate sacrifice, we can take a moment to reflect on what an important role they play in our society, a role of being in the front lines and challenging and protecting us from those that would, in some cases violently, take away those freedoms.
Similar ceremonies were held across the country. It was back in 1998, the federal government officially named the last Sunday of September as Police and Peace Officers Memorial Day. The Winnipeg Jets play the Ottawa Senators tonight in St. John's, Newfoundland, home of Jets AHL affiliate the Whitecaps, after a weekend of losses. The Jets taking on the Carolina Hurricanes in Carolina yesterday afternoon, and it was a tough one for the Jets. Carolina walked away with a shutout, the final score 4-0. The Jets fired 36 shots at Cam Ward, but could not beat the Canes. With the loss, the Jets are 1-3 in the preseason, losing all 3 games on the road. The Brad Pitt drama Moneyball failed to make the cut at the box office this weekend as Disney's re-release of The Lion King reigns supreme for a second week. The Lion King, which was released in 3D, made just over $22 million. That edged out Pitt's baseball drama Moneyball, which took in $20.6 million. Not too shabby, though. And debuting in third spot, the feel-good family film Dolphin Tale. It made just over $20 million. Well, it's a spot most golfers would hate to be in. But hitting the water doesn't seem to be a problem for one player at the Tour Championship. See the amazing shot next in today's TSN Must See Moment.
Okay, team, listen up.
You don't get to say you get it.
We're dealing with a young man who was fighting for what he thought was right, and it didn't turn out the way he had hoped.
Because how could you get it? How could you even know?
He's crash landing.
It doesn't matter. It's too late.
He's at a breaking point here.
What could happen to me?
The last conservative government made huge cuts to health care. So we went to work. We hired 3,000 more nurses and 500 more doctors, put more staff in ERs, and we now have the shortest cancer and cardiac care wait times in Canada. Here's how we'll continue the progress. We'll hire 2,000 nurses and make sure everyone has access to a family doctor. And the NDP will make cancer drugs free for all patients. Working together, we'll make healthcare better for everyone.
I thought a drink would magically solve all my problems.
I thought it would give me courage.
I thought I was only hurting myself.
If alcohol has lost its magic for you, and you can't stop drinking,
I took action, and my life has changed.
Now I have friends that accept me for me.
I've stopped hurting the people that I love.
You'll find us in the phone book, your local newspaper, or on the web. Alcoholics Anonymous.
You're gonna miss it.
I'm not gonna miss it.
You're gonna miss it.
I'm not gonna miss it. Oh, I missed it, didn't I?
Yep.
Wouldn't it be great if you never missed your favorite shows? With the MTS Whole Home PVR, your family can pause, rewind, and replay live TV, so no one will miss a thing. Feeling tired? Pause your show in the living room and finish it in bed. Even watch recorded shows on different TVs at the same time. Keep the whole family happy for as low as $30 a month. MTS Ultimate TV Service.
Third Pounders, three ways to enjoy 100% Angus beef and fresh mouth-watering toppings. Try them today.
7:51, starting to line up on Tache, as you can see on our camera. It's time to check in with CTV's Terry Apostle for a look at weather.
And I've got nothing but good news.
Good.
In fact, today is going to be great. The whole week is going to be great. Let's take a look first at our current conditions. It's 8 degrees right now in Winnipeg, 8 for Portage and Brandon, Fisher Branch, 17 in Dauphin, incredible, 13 for the Paw, 15 in Flin Flon right now. Northern Manitoba is waking up to some incredible temperatures right now, 12 degrees in Thompson and 11 in Island Lake. Here's a look at how things should break down throughout the day. As you put the little ones on the bus, expect about 9 degrees, so they will need a sweater, but they'll be ditching it by noontime. When we get up to 18 degrees and reaching our high about 3:30 today, 22 degrees expected. And today the winds will be from the south between 20 and 30 kilometers an hour. Lots of sunshine in store for us for the 7-day forecast, showing 22 for a high for today, 24 expected for tomorrow, 23 for Wednesday. And then that high pressure ridge that's hanging above us will begin to move eastward. So things will cool down slightly for Thursday, but still staying above normal for this time of year.
All right, we'll check in with Terry in just 9 minutes' time. A great shot from golf's Tour Championship. Here's Brian Mudrick with your TSN must-see moment.
Good morning, everybody. Hope you had a great weekend. Brian Mudrick with you inside the TSN Sports Center newsroom. And it's now time for your must-see moment from Sunday. It involves golf and an outstanding shot. Final round Tour Championship. $11 million on the line. Bill Haas, he's in the water on the second playoff hole. Instead of a drop, he's going for it. And what a shot. Apparently, you can check it up from the water. He would get his par. Next playoff hole, drains it. Wins the Tour Championship and the FedEx Cup. $11.4 million, which is incredible. Coming up tonight on TSN, we have the NFL Monday Nighter, Redskins, Cowboys. It begins with Countdown at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. You're up to date from the Sports Center newsroom. I'm Brian Mudrick. Have a great day.
Our very first in-studio guest is Winnipeg Jet Eric Fair. He'll be with us just before 8:30. But first, we want you to send us your questions for the Winkler native. Get in on it. Tweet us at CTV Morning WPG or email us at morningnews@ctv.ca.
Well, coming up in about 10 after 8, let's celebrate birthdays, anniversaries, and more. But first, our weekly feature, Living Well. Want to make sure your kids get a healthy lunch at school? Some ideas from the experts coming up next.
CTV Morning Live with Elanor Coopsammy, Kris, Laudien, and Terry Apostle. Wake up with Kris, Laudien, Elanor Coopsammy, and Terry Apostle. The latest news, weather, and traffic. CTV Morning Live. Weekday mornings from 6 to 9.
In other words, you are loved. Dogs don't have just one way into our hearts. So why give them just one boring taste? Kibbles and Bits has crunchy kibbles with real meaty bits that dogs love. So every bite tastes delicious. Kibbles and Bits. The bits make it better.
For the jackpot, name the cut of meat that's often called the King of Beef.
I'd like to call my buddy Marty.
You sound confident.
He's a butcher.
Come on, it's prime rib.
Let's get him on the line.
It's prime rib, right?
Yes. Yes, it is. Seems Marty's preoccupied.
The Prime Rib Grandma Burger. It's burger bliss.
There's Mozart's piano sonata in B flat major. There's Schubert's sonata in A minor. And then there's the Hyundai sonata in a 14-step electrocharge paint rotodip. Because beautiful works of art are meant to last.
Manitoba Hydro, it's our oil, it's our future, and it's at risk. Why? Because Hugh McFadden is a privatizer. He admits he played a central role when the PCs broke their promise and privatized MTS. He worked to privatize Ontario Hydro. Now Hugh McFadden says he'll open Manitoba Hydro to private investors. If Hugh McFadden gets the chance, he'll privatize Manitoba Hydro. Our rates will go up, and we'll never get it back. Hugh McFadden and Manitoba Hydro, too big a risk.
It turns out, the cereal that's good for toddlers as a finger food is also the cereal that contains oat fiber. And oat fiber helps lower cholesterol. So it's good for you, too.
Hey, eat your own Cheerios.
Live well on your own terms. Wine Sense, for the love of winemaking.
Amanda Nash, she's a registered dietitian, and you're working with the Heart and Stroke Foundation. And today we're going to be talking about healthy lunches for kids. The kiddies are back in school. We want to know how they can eat healthy. So we have a beautiful, it's a meal for children, a snack for myself, but it's all laid out here. Maybe you can tell me what this is and why it's so healthy.
Well, you're right that it's back to school time, which is an exciting time of year. It's a great time to start new routines. And with that, meal planning is so important. So planning out snacks and lunches for your kids, it's a great time to make sure you're making those healthy choices to optimize learning, creativity, and growth. Here we have an example of a snacks and lunch. So here for a snack, you can send your kids with some cottage cheese and some peaches. For the lunch, we have a mini pizza with some veggies, and that mini pizza recipe is available on the Health Check website as well as the Heart and Stroke Foundation website. And then for a snack, a homemade granola bar. Again, recipe is available on our website, and a half a cup of a juice is a great snack.
So a homemade granola bar, I mean, that's a great idea. Usually people wouldn't even think about that, but how easy is that to make?
It's quite easy to make. The only thing you want to be aware of is if there's peanut allergies in the school, because some recipes for granola bars will have peanuts in them or nut products, and some schools will not allow that.
Okay, now as we move back here, you have some other examples, but first you mentioned the Health Checker website and the meal planner. You have that on a website?
We do. The Health Check website has a variety of tools that you can use for back-to-school planning. Some of the tools they have is a new app for your phone, and on that app you can download different recipes, and with that recipe it will give you a grocery list as well well as the nutrient data. The Health Check website also has five weekly meal plans of snacks and lunches. It gives you ideas of what you can do for your kids and recipes for some of those key foods as well.
Oh, that sounds fantastic. All right, let's get to this next lunch or snack. Why don't you tell us a little about this one?
So for this one, our snack is going to start with some whole grain cereal and some milk. And then again, milk so important for the calcium, the vitamin D. If your school does have a milk program, I strongly suggest that you join that milk program and then your child can get a nice cold, refreshing milk with their lunch. For the lunch here with this meal, we have some bean and cheese quesadillas, and this recipe again available on our website, with some veggies and an apple. For a snack, we have some yogurt as well as some fruit. And again, try and make it fun using different colors for your containers, make it fun for the kids. And then here I put some of the grapes onto a kebab stick, but you'd want to cut off that pointy end. I forgot to do
that. Safety first, that's right.
So it makes it fun. The kids are going to enjoy it and they're going to have fun eating it as well.
Now if you move down a little here, this third example, you have a nice picnic basket, it looks like, and also dip with the veggies. What's in that dip?
This is a hummus. Hummus is a great source of protein. It's going to give you some fiber as well, especially for the nut-free schools. Hummus is a great alternative to peanut butter. So here we have some veggies and hummus, and that's a great snack. For the lunch, you're right, a picnic lunch. We call this Farmer in the Dell, and that recipe, again, available on the website. And we have a half of a whole grain English muffin and a cheese stick there for a snack as well.
All right, Amanda, thanks a lot for joining us on Living Well today. I have to put this on your head because you have passed the Heart and Stroke Foundation test.
Might be a little small, but
thank you very much for this.
Thank you.
Morning. Thank you so much for joining us on our first CTV Morning Live show. It's been going well, I think, so far.
Let us know
if it isn't. Lots coming up today with news and traffic and weather every 10 minutes.
Yeah, we'll introduce you to the whole team. We also have Jesse Carlson. He's on the streets. And Kristen Hirsch at the web desk. And we want to hear from you. So if you want, you can always get in touch with us at morningnews@ctv.ca. That's our email address. But first, we're going to check on the headlines.
Well, Winnipeg police are investigating after a body was discovered in the Red River.
Brandon University's faculty gets ready for a strike vote.
Plus, the Winnipeg Blue Bombers lose more than just a game against the Argos. We'll have more on that disappointing loss in a minute.
Seven injuries.
I know. Oh, it's so sad. Did you watch that, Terry?
I did. And you know, at the end, I was so confused because I'm kind of waiting for and then it was like, oh, the time's out.
Yeah.
I guess that's it.
Yeah, that was it. They lost by a point.
Well, I know. So disappointing.
What are we going to see for, I hope you have good news when it comes to weather this morning.
I've got great news, Eleanor. In fact, if you're not up and at 'em yet, what are you waiting for? It's a gorgeous day, but you know what? I changed my mind. Stay put till 9 o'clock and then get out and enjoy the gorgeous day. It is currently 8 degrees right now, winds from the south at 15 kilometers an hour, and the humidity at 95%. Now, it's not just Winnipeg having a gorgeous morning. Everyone across the province waking up to above normal temperatures. It's 8 degrees for Portage and for Brandon. A very mild morning, too, in northern Manitoba. It's looking good, and everybody is going to be seeing plenty of sunshine today. Here in Winnipeg, we're expecting to get up to about 22 degrees. And keeping in mind that 15 is normal for this time of year, we are well above that, not just for today, but that trend will continue on right through till the middle of the week. We will see things cooling down ever so slightly, but still staying above normal. So nobody will be able to complain about this. For our first official week of fall, it's still feeling more like summer temperatures. Great weather in store for us. On our drive, unfortunately, things are getting busy, and we've got a couple of crashes. Southbound Pembina Highway approaching McGill. A three-car crash in the area. We've got emergency crews on the scene. Now, the bulk of traffic is traveling north in the area, so southbound isn't exactly lining up, but please use some caution through there. And another crash, Firmore at Autumnwood. Again, use some caution. Those couple of spots will be slow on your drive, but for the most part, other areas are still moving fairly well. As a shot of the Disraeli.
It's 8:03. Thanks a lot for that, Terry. Taking a look at the news headlines. Winnipeg police are investigating after a body was found on the banks of the Red River this weekend. It was found yesterday afternoon in the water off Henderson Highway. Right now, police aren't giving any details about the gender or age of the person. We do know emergency crews were called out to the 2100 block off Henderson Highway near Knowles Avenue just before 2. Details are still emerging. Police won't say if it's connected to the drowning of 6-year-old Nathaniel Farassi. He disappeared beneath the ice in December. His body hasn't been found. The Winnipeg Police Service Underwater Search and Recovery Unit is part of the investigation, which is continuing.
The Brandon University Faculty Association will vote this week on whether or not to hit the picket lines. Ballots are being mailed out today to the 240 association members. Officials expect the strike vote to take about a week to 10 days to complete. The association president says contract negotiations will continue during that time. At issue are salary, benefits, and contract language.
A shocking find in Libya, where authorities say a mass grave has been found in Tripoli with the remains of more than 1,200 people. The National Transition Council says the remains are believed to be that of the victims of a prison massacre back in 1996. Human rights groups say Muammar Gaddafi's forces shot up to 2,000 inmates who were protesting conditions at their facility. The discovery comes as NATO planes and rebel forces pound Gaddafi's hometown of Sirte in a major assault to capture the city.
It's a game head coach Paul Lapalisse said his team should have won. The Bombers remain the best in the CFL despite suffering a single point loss to the league's last place team, the Toronto Argonauts. The 25-24 loss Saturday in Toronto was costly in more ways than one. Seven Bombers were unable to finish the outing, including quarterback Buck Pierce. The Bombers starter re-aggravated his bruised ribs and was forced to leave the game prior to the half. Also injured in the contest, backup QB Alex Brink, who left in the fourth quarter after he injured his shoulder on his non-throwing arm. Third string pivot Justin Goltz entered the game without a single pass to his name this season. Meanwhile, running backs Fred Reed and Carl Volney left the game with knee injuries. Offensive lineman Brendan Labatt and defensive lineman Doug Brown and Rodney Fritz didn't complete the game as well. The Bombers will reevaluate each injured player over the next couple days, but the top concern, of course, is Pierce, who is questionable for Friday's East Division showdown against Montreal.
Talk about a high-flying thrill. A professional wingsuit flyer from the States has successfully performed a jump and dive through a cave in China. Jeb Corliss jumped from a helicopter nearly 2,000 meters above the Tiananmen Cave. Look at that. He flew right through it. It took two tries for Corliss to make the jump successfully. The equipment on his chute malfunctioned and forced him to take a detour. He's the first wingsuit stuntman to fly in Chinese skies. That's absolutely amazing.
That is great.
Look at the speed he's going.
If you were off just a little bit, disaster.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, like when they said his first attempt was unsuccessful, you always wonder, oh man.
Oh my goodness.
But he made it.
Well, we're going to check in with CTV's Rochelle Legacy once again. She is at Heritage Park School. And what are you going to talk to us about now at this hour?
Well, I'm going to introduce you to Dan Saris. He's a school patrol supervisor here at Heritage School. It's also his birthday today, but we'll talk about that later.
Okay.
As a school patrol supervisor, are you concerned by this study that CAA Manitoba just released?
Yeah, I'd say it is quite concerning, especially when the young kids are out there trying to make it safe for people to cross the street and the young kids coming to school. I do see it quite a bit driving to school every day, but yeah, hopefully people will wake up once they see the study and I guess drive safer on the roads.
Because you have kids that are helping keep kids safe on the streets, kids like Cole and Cade here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's introduce you to, this is Cole and this is Cade. Hi guys, how are you?
Good.
So you're patrolling today?
Yeah.
Have you seen any close calls on the road when you've been doing your important job?
Yeah, last year we were, it was snowy out, and then on the curb over there, there was a truck, it came, slipped, and hit the curb.
Was that scary for you?
Yep, very scary.
And scary because it's slippery, so they don't know how to stop, right, in time?
Yep.
Do you have any advice for drivers?
Not really.
Maybe slow down?
Yeah.
Okay, well, thanks, you guys. This is going on their second year as patrollers, and later on we're going to get shots of them in action as they do their job. Now, Dan, I just wanted to ask you another question. Do you have any warnings for your patrollers, knowing what you know now?
I think I just tell them to maybe take a big step back from the curb, be careful, and make sure to cross the students when there's a break in traffic, and I guess just to be care for all the time, and if there is a problem, then come and talk to me, and then I can talk to the police, and hopefully we can fix the problem.
All right, well, thanks so much, and happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
Coming up later, we'll talk to CAA Manitoba about what they hope to do with this information now that they have it.
All right, thanks a lot, Rochelle. We'll be checking in with Rochelle one more time this morning. It's coming up to 8:09, time for Let's Celebrate. Now, this is a daily segment where we'd like to feature your loved ones, marking some sort of milestone, whether it's a birthday, anniversary, graduation, you name it, and today we have a special one.
We do. We'd like to wish happy birthday to Rochelle. Oh, look at her. What a cutie. Four already. We can't believe it. You brighten each and every day. All our love, Grandma and Grandpa Howlett. So that's so sweet. If you've got any pictures of and know somebody who's celebrating a birthday or anniversary, just like Rochelle, be sure to send them in. Send us a photo. Tell us who we're honoring and why. And send it in to celebrate@ctv.ca.
Perhaps a future chef. I also have one more birthday to throw out there.
Oh, yeah?
Shamu the killer whale is turning 26.
Okay.
She lives at SeaWorld. And it's her 26th birthday. Quite an amazing feat for Shamu.
I hope they have a big party for
That's
her.
That's right. The feeler's
what
next
kind of
for
cake would that be?
I'm not herring cake.
Fish. Well, anyway.
Well, believe it or not, it's time for another giveaway here on CTV Morning Live. We have one pair of
cool.
front row tickets to Cirque du Soleil's Michael Jackson, The Immortal Tour.
That's right. It is coming up October 26th and 27th at the MTS Center. And we want to give you a chance to win tickets. But in order to qualify, we're going to test how well you know the King of Pop songs.
Uh-oh, this is a tough one. We're going to read off some lyrics to one of his songs. Now, you want to enter by email at wpgcontests@ctv.ca with the correct name of that song, and you'll be entered into a draw to win those front row tickets. Now, here's today's clue. I'm not going to sing it. I'm going to get Elanor to sing it.
I'm not singing. I'll just read it. People always told me, be careful what you do, and don't go around breaking young girls' hearts.
That's what you need. Yeah.
Send us your answers at winnipegcontests@ctv.ca. I'm never going to hear the end of that.
Yeah, I hope you didn't give that away.
Include your first and last name. Be sure you do that. Your email address, phone number, and the correct answer to the trivia question posed. And we will announce the winner of our Last Chance Avril Lavigne ticket giveaway coming up soon.
Yeah, that's also at the MTS Center. But that was very nice rendition of Michael Jackson's song there. We'll work on that.
We're not going to tell you what song it is.
That's right. Well, it's 8:11, time now for a check-in at the Weather Center with Terry Apostle. Terry, any Michael Jackson lyrics you want to add to that?
Well, not necessarily lyrics, but you want to see my moonwalk?
Oh,
you know
very
what? The
nice.
Floor director was doing that too, making fun of me. That was a good moonwalk.
Not bad, hey?
Not bad. Well, will you be doing that moonwalk under the sun today?
Oh, nice.
Oh, I will be. You know, in fact, everybody can get outside and do the moonwalk today. Loving the conditions. It's a gorgeous week ahead. 8 degrees currently, winds from the south of 15 kilometers an hour, the humidity at 95%. If you take a look at our satellite radar, you can see nothing is showing up. It's just pure sunshine in store for us today. So let's take a look at what we can expect for our high temperatures across Manitoba today. In the northern part of the province, things are looking very good. A little bit of cloud coverage in there, but still temperatures well above normal for this time of year. As we move a little bit further east, still temperatures around the mid-20s. Nobody's going to be complaining in Flin Flon or the Paw. Norway House also looking good. Lots of sunshine coming your way as we move a little bit further south for Swan River, Dauphin, Brandon. Plenty of sunshine and temperatures around 24, 25 degrees, looking very good. A little bit cooler here to the east, 22 degrees though, that's still well above normal, and lots of sunshine. Barron's River at 21, and then as we move into Ontario, still plenty of sunshine and temperatures 20 and 21 degrees, looking very good. Here's a look too at your long range forecast showing today 22, tomorrow 24, staying above normal for the whole week, right into the weekend with lots of sunshine coming your way. It's looking fantastic. Unfortunately, our drive not moving quite as well. We've got a crash, and this is on Pembina Highway at McGillivray, right around here. It's affecting southbound traffic. We've got emergency crews on the scene. A three-vehicle crash. It will take some time to clear up. Most of the traffic, though, heading northbound at this time. We've got Jesse out on the streets, and we'll be checking in with him throughout the morning.
Well, good morning, Terry. Just on Furmore here, going eastbound at Autumnwood. You can see on the left side of your TV screen, there is a police cruiser and an ambulance. There was a crash here. Things seem to be all cleaned up here. Actually, fire crews actually getting back in their vehicle, so traffic going to be cleaning up here. Now, I can tell you, eastbound Notre Dame, around that McPhillips-Arlington area, there was a two-car crash. One of those cars has left the scene, so things will get back to normal pretty soon there. Drop us a tweet if you see any crashes or stalls at CTV. CTV Morning WPG. Tell us what you see. That's it for now. Back to you guys.
8:13, time to turn our attention from traffic to pumpkins.
That's right, it's coming up to that time of year.
Halloween's still a month away, but apparently everyone's growing these pumpkins. And do you remember Charlie Brown's great pumpkin?
Of course, love Charlie Brown's. Right? Yeah, it was big. But these crows have nothing on the great pumpkin, let me tell you. This is the Utah annual giant pumpkin weigh-in. And look at the size of these things.
Yikes, potential jack-o'-lanterns. A lot of carving would be needed for that one. Farmers from across the state of Utah brought in their massive gourds in hope of breaking last year's record of more than 1,100 pounds.
That's crazy. Most of the growers say the best part of this contest is finding ways to use the pumpkin once it's all over. Now, I mean, seriously, how many pumpkin pies? You know what? All the pumpkin pies go to their Utah State Fair probably.
Yeah,
after.
Exactly. And they're saying the best secrets are you need good seed, good soil, and hard work. And I love pumpkin seeds, but how big would a pumpkin seed be from one of those?
You know, they say the bigger, though, if you look at zucchinis, if they get bigger, they actually don't taste as well as good. So maybe it's, hopefully those pumpkins taste good. I'd like to try pumpkin pie from one of those.
Well, I'd like to try pumpkin pie anytime.
Yeah, good point.
Well, it's something some groups say can't be done without eating into their profits.
But a local school says that is not true. What the University of Winnipeg is serving that's good for you and their bottom line.
Watch. More Canadians are finding bargain real estate in the U.S. Consumer Watch's Karen Rosnick explores what you need to know to ensure your deal doesn't go south.
Consumer Watch, Monday on CTV News. CTV News, weeknights at 6 with Gord LeClaire and Marilee Caruso. Now for a look at what's up in Manitoba.
If you or someone you know is in need of gently used clothing, toys, or household goods, the 16th annual clothing giveaway is happening Saturday, October 1st. The event takes place at 170 St. Mary's Road from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. All items are free to anyone in need, plus complimentary coffee, soup, and children's activities will also be available.
Submit your public service announcement online at ctvwinnipeg.ca.
Want truly better hair color? New Garnier Nutrice triple nourishes because nourished hair means better color. Color that's rich, more radiant, incredibly silky. And every last grip disappears for nourished hair. Better color. New Garnier Nutrice, made in Canada.
Manitoba Hydro. It's our oil. It's our future. And it's at risk. Why? Because Hugh McFadden is a privatizer. He admits he played a central role when the PCs broke their promise and privatized MTS. He worked to privatize Ontario Hydro. Now Hugh McFadden says he'll open Manitoba Hydro to private investors. If Hugh McFadden gets the chance, he'll privatize Manitoba Hydro. Our rates will go up, and we'll never get it back. Hugh McFadden and Manitoba Hydro, too big a risk.
No competitor looks at trucks the way GMC engineers do. That's why the Sierra is engineered with variable valve timing, active fuel management, and a 6-speed hydromatic transmission. So it's the only truck that delivers over 300 horsepower of acceleration and trailering power when you need it, without sacrificing best-in-class V8 fuel efficiency. The Sierra from GMC. When you never compromise, you have nothing to hide.
The Treehouse Solid Wood Furniture is your value center for the finest in Canadian-made furniture.
At the Treehouse, we sell direct from our factory.
Every piece is 100% Canadian maple, oak, and pine. Solid wood through and through, built in Manitoba.
Like our signature 7-piece bedroom suite for just $14.99.
Plus your choice of 5-drawer chest or mattress set absolutely free.
The Treehouse Furniture, your factory direct connection to great quality and great prices.
Why have one flavor when you can have them all? New snacking cups from Häagen-Dazs. Our passion is ice cream.
Closed captioning is brought to you in part by Pronamel. Helps protect your tooth enamel against the acid wear your morning orange juice can cause.
Welcome back. You're watching CTV Morning Live. That's a shot of southbound traffic going down Disraeli Bridge, and it's starting to back up a little bit. It is 8:15 and 9 degrees. Well, it's the city's 32nd homicide of the year, but for now, Winnipeg police are releasing little information on the murder. A man was found dead just before 4:30 yesterday morning in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor Streets. Police blocked off those streets and set up a white tent for several hours as the homicide and ident unit, along with the medical examiner, were on scene. Neighbors say they heard gunshots, but police will not confirm how the man died.
A passerby who had walked by and stated that there was an injured male at this location. We did get there. Our officers did arrive on scene and located an adult male who was, in fact, deceased.
Police say the investigation is in its early stages and won't say if it is gang-related. There is no word on the victim's name. Anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers. Well, the husband of a Montreal-born woman whose body was found encased in concrete is now charged with her murder. The arrest came one day after neighbors held a vigil outside the New Jersey apartment building where the victim lived with her husband and daughter. It's also where Lair's remains were found Friday, 6 weeks after her husband, Stephen Lacuna, reported her missing. Her body will be returned to Montreal for a funeral. A massive protest is planned in Ottawa today to rally against a proposed pipeline that would carry oil from Alberta to Texas.
Environmental sending that message to Prime Minister Harper and sending that message loud and clear that enough is enough.
Environmental activist groups have organized a civil disobedience demonstration on Parliament Hill. Prime Minister Stephen Harper has defended the proposed Keystone XL pipeline, saying it will create thousands of jobs in Canada. Some of the unions representing oil sands workers disagree. They say the pipeline would employ far more people south of the border, where the oil would likely be refined. A number of protests involving high-profile arrests took place in Washington last month. Well, a little food for thought. While we might think our children would select junk food for lunch, given the chance, local school is seeing success with its new healthy menu.
We got broccoli, mushrooms, hard-boiled egg, celery.
In the heart of our downtown, the University of Winnipeg is serving up a healthy and tasty menu that still includes some student favorites with a twist. On the menu, you'll find salads and stir fries along with chicken fingers and hamburgers and fries. But what makes it different is that the fries are hand cut and the bread is whole wheat. Since changing its menu, the U of W says sales have gone up 20%. And the healthy concept is drawing attention. Other schools have already contacted the university about the program. Well, it's time now to take a look at weather, and Terry Apostle joins us. So it seems like it's starting out to be a pretty nice day outside.
It is. Eleanor, I know you like the hot and dry weather.
Hotter the better.
Right. And, you know, for this time of year, nobody is really going to complain about what we're seeing. It is 8 degrees currently. Winds are from the south at 15 kilometers an hour. The humidity at 95%. But let's take a look at what we can expect today for our high. 22 degrees, not bad at all. Lots of sunshine in store. And today, the winds will be from the south at 30 kilometers an hour. Now overnight you're going to see that drop down to about 10 degrees. Winds will taper off slightly, still from the south at 15 kilometers an hour. And then for tomorrow, 24 degrees. Incredible weather. Lots of sunshine once again. And winds will be from the west tomorrow at about 15 kilometers an hour. But take a look at this. It's the long range forecast showing lots of sunshine in store for us for Wednesday, 23. By Thursday, things will be cooling off slightly because that high pressure ridge above us will begin to move a little bit eastward. But still, 17 degrees is above normal for this time of year, and we'll stay there for the rest of the week right into the weekend. It's looking very, very good. Lots of sunshine. Here's a lovely weather picture that was sent to us. This one taken near Morris, Manitoba. Beautiful shot of the sunset there. Incredible. And look at this one. A bald eagle. Looks like a beautiful summer day, but it's fall, of course. Summer-like temperatures in fall. Please keep those weather pictures coming. Winnipeg weather at ctv.ca.
Thanks a lot, Terry. It's 8:22. Time now to welcome our very first guest to CTV Morning Live, Winnipeg Jets forward, Eric Fear. Good morning, Eric.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Well, it's our pleasure. Now, you're a Winkler native. You played your junior in Brandon. How does it feel to basically come home to play in the NHL?
It's going to be a great experience. I'm really honored to be a part of this organization right now. It's an exciting time in Winnipeg, and to be a Manitoba boy, it's great to be a part of it.
Now, you were in Washington for three or four seasons.
Yep.
Yeah, and then you were traded this offseason. When you found out you were traded to Winnipeg. What was your emotions then?
Well, it was definitely mixed emotions. It was the first time I got traded, and I didn't really know how to take it. But knowing that I was coming back to Manitoba made it a lot easier. And obviously, I know how passionate the fans are here in Winnipeg, so it's going to be an exciting year for everybody.
I just got to ask you, playing in Washington with Alex Ovechkin, one of the biggest stars in the league, is that guy as amazing as he looks on TV?
Yeah, definitely. He's an amazing player, but he's also an amazing guy off the ice. He's a great captain, a great guy to hang out with off the ice. He's got that same smile on his face in the dressing room as he does on the ice.
Now, the team's in training camp right now. You had shoulder surgery back in May. How's that recovery going?
Recovery's coming pretty well. I'm out as long as I've been expected to so far, and I'm trying to do as much as I can to get back as early as possible, but it doesn't look like I'll be ready for the opening game of the season, but I'm doing my best to get back as soon as I can.
You were in the building last Tuesday for the first exhibition game. What was the atmosphere like in that? As a player, how did it make you feel?
It was awesome. As a player, you want to see fans get into a preseason game and see how excited they are, but being a Manitoba guy, it was real special seeing the guys take the ice for the first time. I saw the team when they left, and it was tough to swallow, so it was great to see the team back on the ice.
Now, we're big on Twitter here at CTV Morning Live. I noticed you also sent out a lot of tweets. You saw Moneyball yesterday.
Yeah, I saw Moneyball. I thought it was a great movie.
Yeah.
I like using Twitter just to get out to my fans and give them an opportunity to interact with me. And if they have questions, I answer them or stuff like that. So I think it's a great tool to use for sure.
All right, so we know Moneyball got your thumbs up. What kind of guidelines does the league have for you in tweets?
They've slowly got a few more guidelines. I haven't read the full protocol yet, but I think they just want to limit our tweets on game day or tweets, negative tweets about stuff. So we're trying to keep things happy and positive on Twitter.
Yeah, well, that's good. Well, we like to tweet. We ask for audience interaction. So we have a few questions for you here this morning from our audience. And actually, Ray, he wants to know if the team's performance in the preseason is kind of what you expected.
I definitely think in the first game, that we were going to come out pretty hard, obviously with the fans cheering us on and everything. But, preseason, it's tough to judge because some games teams have their full lineups in. Sometimes they want to take a look at young guys. So it's really tough to judge by preseason how the team's going to be in the regular season.
All right. And Sam wants to know, if you weren't a hockey player, what would you be doing?
That's a tough question. I've asked myself a million times. I think I like building stuff with my hands, so maybe I'd be a carpenter or something like that.
All right, excellent. Well, just one last question I want to fit in. What's the best thing about playing hockey in Winnipeg going to be?
Couple things. I think one of the great things is going to be that my family is going to be around to share this year with me. I think something they've really looked forward to the last couple weeks, being around to watch the games. And I think just to experience the Winnipeg Jets in their first year with the franchise being back, I think it's going to be really special.
All right, Eric. Well, best of luck this season. Good luck with the recovery. You think maybe October, November?
I'm thinking November. I'm really hoping to be back as soon as I can.
All right. Well, thanks for being our inaugural guest here in studio.
It feels great to be the inaugural guest. Thank you for having me.
Best of luck this season. Winnipeg Jets forward Eric Fair. Stay tuned for CTV Morning Live. We have plenty more coming up after the break.
Yay!
Stay safe with Crime Watch reporter Stacey Ashley on CTV News at 6.
So I'm the luckiest guy in the world that you walked into my life today.
More emotion.
Brother, brother.
More X-Factor.
Obnoxious. Argumentative.
You know what?
That was mature.
Stop doing it. It's not right.
This is insane.
An all-new X-Factor. Wednesday at 8, 7 Central on CTV.
This province is too important to be left to two political parties that spend all their time fighting about everything. Everything except the issues that matter to you. Like fixing health care, taking the smart approach to fighting crime, and creating opportunities through jobs and education.
I'm Liberal leader Dr. John Gerard. On October 4th, vote for strong families and healthy communities. There is a better choice.
Reinventing the vacuum cleaner has been an obsession of mine for the past 17 years. It began with cyclone technology. For me, the fundamental answer to loss of suction. Next, we eliminated bags. Then came our ball, a radical alternative to fixed wheels. Our mission is simple. Solve the obvious problems others seem to ignore.
Everyone loves designer fall fashions, but you deserve great value too. No problem. Use Fashionomics, where brand name fashion and economical prices come together. You can get double the designer fashions for your money at Winners. Because hundreds of brand names are always up to 60% less. Winners, find fabulous for less.
Now for a look at what's up in Manitoba.
If you have some spare time on Tuesday or Thursday afternoons and love to curl, the Fort Rouge Ladies Curling Club is looking for you. They will hold a curling clinic October 4th for those who are interested. Whether you are a beginner or a pro, they want to hear from you. Call 475-0888 for more information.
Submit your public service announcement online at ctvwinnipeg.ca.
This is Jack, and this is Jack's mouth. Jack wants a mouthwash loaded with cleaning power. His mouth just wants to avoid the intense taste. But Jack has just discovered Listerine Total Care Zero. It contains no alcohol, and it's less intense, but still has the all-in-one performance that kills germs and does a lot more. No other mouthwash combines these eight benefits in one in a no-alcohol, less intense formula. Listerine Total Care Zero. Intense clean without the intense taste.
Monday on Consumer Watch.
More Canadians are finding bargain real estate in the U.S. Consumer Watch's Karen Rosnick explores what you need to know to ensure your deal doesn't go south.
Consumer Watch, Monday on CTV News.
It's 8:30. Welcome to the inaugural edition of CTV Morning Live. That's inaugural. Yeah. Or inaugural.
We knew what you meant.
I added another syllable there.
The first ever.
I like to create words. Well, we're going to introduce you to the whole team this morning. Carrie Apostle's in the Weather Center. We get to her every 10 minutes. Also, Rochelle Legacy, she's on location at Heritage Park School this morning talking about school zone safety.
That's right. And we also have Kristen Hirsch on the web desk. And in about 15 minutes, Consumer Watch reporter Karen Rosnick will be in here to tell you about the great property deals in the Sun Belt.
That's right. You want to get on that. But first, let's take a look at what's making news in Winnipeg.
Well, Winnipeg police investigate the city's 32nd homicide of the year, but are not yet saying how the victim died.
A Quebec family is in mourning after three adults drowned while trying to save their children.
And a rare disease that left 22 Canadian families searching for answers and a cure. We'll show you what that is coming up shortly.
Right now, though, it's time to head to the roof and check in with Terry Apostle on the Weather Center. Looks like a gorgeous morning out there, Terry. Is that going to continue throughout the whole day?
It is, Kris. In fact, above normal temperatures for not just today, but the whole week ahead will be an incredible one. As we wake up now, it is already 9 degrees, a very mild morning, a little bit of a breeze, though. It's from the south, 17 kilometers an hour, the humidity at 93%. Now, Winnipeg is having a gorgeous morning, but so is everybody all throughout the province this morning. In Portage, Brandon, Churchill, everybody sitting at 8 degrees, looking a little bit better in Thompson at 11, in the Paw, 13 degrees, a very, very mild morning right across the board, and everybody will be seeing plenty of sunshine today. It's like the Disney Zippity-Doo-Dah Day song. Lots of sunshine for everyone here in Winnipeg. We should expect a high of 22 degrees, so a gorgeous day, and like I said, above normal temperatures that'll linger right through the middle of the weekend into the weekend, so nobody will have anything to complain about as far as the forecast goes. As far as the drive goes, we do have a couple of glitches, unfortunately. Now, we had a couple of crashes earlier on that have since been cleared up. Now, that's great news. So southbound Pembina Highway at McGilvery, all cleared up. No issues there anymore. But right in the downtown area, we're now having a traffic light issue. This is Hargrave at York. So things are really starting to stack up right in the downtown area. And, of course, we've got Jesse out taking a closer look at how your drive is going. Let's check in with him and the dash cam.
Yeah,
Well, good morning, Terry, and good morning to all of you. And I can tell you that the people watching at home, Terry is not a liar. Southbound on McGilvery and Pemina, it all is clear, that three-car crash. Now, what I can tell you the truth is, in Manitoba, especially here in Winnipeg this morning, you cannot talk while talking on a cell phone. I saw a young lady driving two kids in the back seat talking on a cell phone. Please be safe out there. Not saying that was connected to any crashes this morning, but please watch where you're going in front of you, just like our live cam right now. All right, that's it from now as I drive deeper into the city. Enjoy the rest of your morning. Back to you guys.
So don't be on your phone illegally, because apparently our traffic guy, Jesse Carlson, will rat you out. Well, a tragic turn in an attempted rescue in Quebec as three adults drowned trying to save their children from a raging river. It happened on Saturday near St. Fulgence along the Wapishish River. Two boys waded too far into the water and got caught in the current. The fathers of the boys and one of their mothers jumped in to help. The boys were rescued, but the parents disappeared. The mother's body was retrieved almost immediately. The bodies of the men were found yesterday morning.
It's the city's 32nd homicide of the year, but right now Winnipeg police are not yet saying much about the investigation. Just before 4:30 yesterday morning, a man was found dead in the area of Boyd Avenue between Andrews and McGregor Streets. Police blocked off the street and set up a white tent for several hours. Neighbors say they heard gunshots, but police won't confirm how the man died. There is no word on the victim's name or how he died. Anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers.
Well, it's a parent's worst nightmare. Your child suddenly develops strange shakes and other symptoms, but doctors don't know what's wrong. That's what more than 20 Canadian families are facing with a recently discovered and rare disease. A warning first, though, some viewers may find the images you're about to see a little disturbing.
Who is it?
That darling was 3-year-old Jaden before she started acting strangely, developing an odd walk, twitching, and other frightening symptoms that left her parents baffled. It wasn't until her spinal fluids were sent to a Pennsylvania researcher that they learned the cause of the problem, a brand new disease called anti-NMDAR encephalitis. It causes the body to attack the brain, but because it was just discovered 4 years ago, it's often misdiagnosed. Doctors say it can be treated with drugs, and 75% of the victims recover. And a year after treatment, Jaden is now perfectly normal.
It's coming up to 8:35 to politics now. We've got just over a week until we head to the polls, and there are a few tight races political observers are closely watching. In Brandon West, only 56 votes separated the Progressive Conservatives from the NDP in the last election. MLA Rick Baratzik is not seeking re-election, and a Brandon University political scientist says the new candidates could face a similar outcome. The PC candidate is businessman Reg Helwer. The NDP have former Brandon School Board Chair Jim Murray. Rounding out the candidates are teacher George Burry for the Liberals and Lisa Gallagher for the Communists. The candidates say the main issues in the riding include infrastructure, violent crime, education, and health care.
American swimmer Diana Nyad has ended her latest attempt to become the first person to swim between Cuba and Florida without a shark cage. The 62-year-old Nyad was about halfway through when the stings from a Portuguese man-of-war jellyfish temporarily paralyzed her spine. Doctors warned her another sting could actually be life-threatening. Nyad made another try last month but had to quit because of shoulder pain and an asthma attack.
Wow, that's amazing. She looks in great shape for 62.
Yeah, fantastic shape.
Incredible. Well, we want to announce the winner of our last chance giveaway for Avril Lavigne tickets.
Darlene of Winnipeg is our first contest winner here on CTV Morning Live, our inaugural winner.
That's right. Very nice pronunciation.
Someone will be contacting you soon, so congratulations.
It's 8:36. Now it's time to head over to the web desk and Kristen Hirsch. Kristen, I know we just had our first big winner. That's exciting. What exciting stuff do you have for us at the smart board?
Well, what's exciting is that she won two tickets, meaning she has an extra ticket for maybe a web reporter.
Nice. Trying to sneak in.
Maybe a little slither in there. All right. So at this time in the morning, this is when I get to talk about all of the viewer comments. And earlier this morning, I said, I really want the viewers and I want Winnipeg and Manitoba to be like my co-host, because you two get each other.
Yeah.
And I'm all alone over here with my smart board. So I want to work with the city to get everything you want to talk about out there on the wavelengths via Twitter, Facebook, you pick your poison, whatever you'd like. So let's take a look first off at our Facebook page. This is what it looks like, CTV Morning Live. And I just want to come down here. We just had Eric Fair on. And some of the comments that you guys had for questions for him were amazing. I loved Sam's. If you were not a hockey player, what would you be doing? Now, Kris and Elanor, if you two weren't hosts, what would you be doing? Kris, what do you think?
I'd be sleeping right now.
You wouldn't be getting up at 2:45 in the morning. I'd probably be a teacher, I think.
I think that you teach me every day.
Aww.
Oh, so cute. All right, let's move on here. I'm going to show you our Twitter page just so you can learn a little bit about that. Earlier this morning, I put out there that Rochelle Legacy is on location learning about school zone safety. What's the most ridiculous thing you've seen drivers doing? So we had one comment come in. Let's take a look at that. And this right here is from Chase. Distracted drivers are usually, or they seem to be the same ones who are light-to-light racers. You know those light-to-light racers on Portage. So you're not safe because Jesse's out on the streets watching you.
And he will rat you out.
He totally will rat you out. Now, finally, I have one more lesson for everyone. This is our main page, ctvwinnipeg.ca. This is what it looks like. But what you want to look for are these two good-looking people right here. There they are. And you want to click on them. Because it's going to take you to our page, and here it is. This is where you can see all the videos from Choose Your News. I'm not pumping my own tires per se, but those are my segments. You might want to check them out, and they're kind of fun.
You do a fantastic job on the web page. Yeah. And the
start your day
page.
Off right.
Is that a very large Yoda there? I see.
Yeah, that's a giant Yoda. I report on very important things, and I actually just caught Eric Fair on my iPad, and I'm going to put that up on the Facebook page because there's some behind-the-scenes questions I asked him that, Kris, you didn't get to. They're very intense, like his favorite book.
All right. Well, we'll be waiting for those. You can check those out on ctvwinnipeg.ca. Thank you very much, Kris.
You're welcome.
Well, it's time now to check in once again with CTV's Rochelle Legacy. She is down at Heritage Park School talking about school zone safety.
That's right. And actually, I'm joined by Angèle Fauché from CAA Manitoba. Now, one thing we were talking about, a lot of parents want to drop their kids off safely, but because there are no stopping zones in many of these school zones, they have a hard time finding a safe place to drop off their kids. And so that's something CAA Manitoba is hoping to discuss, right?
Yes, definitely. And that's one thing that we really opened our eyes to when we were in the school zones on Wednesday doing our back-to-school safety assessment. We know that parents don't really want to disobey the law and the signs and stuff like that. So basically, we want to find where's the best spot to drop off your kids. If it's a little farther away, that's okay. Park where it's safe to do so and walk with your kids into the school. And that's probably the safest way to, you know, lower the school zone congestion and then get a little more active too.
And perhaps more kids should start walking to school, right?
Yes, definitely. I remember when I was a kid, we always used to walk. So definitely walking is something that, you know, lowers a lot of the congestion that's going on. And then, it, you know, it has a sense of community and it's really good for the kids to do.
So if parents are concerned about safety, one of the things that you might be working on is actually creating kind of a buddy system for children, right, as they walk to school?
Definitely. If you know a lot of kids in your area that go to school together, then why not everyone walk together? And that could be a buddy system, so to make sure everyone's safe. So that's definitely something that we would encourage, and we would help if anyone's looking to do that.
And that's, of course, that would ease congestion in school zones. Now, if people want more information about your study, what website should they check out?
CAAManitoba.com. We have all of the stats on there, and you can also give me a call. My number is 262-6134.
Perfect. Thank you, Angèle.
Yeah,
and
no problem.
That wraps it up for us here this morning, so we'll have a great day.
Great. Thanks, Rochelle. Where are you going to be tomorrow?
Tomorrow, we're still working on that, Elanor.
Okay. Well, I thought you might know. Okay.
She'll be at a fantastic location tomorrow morning. Thanks a lot for that, Rochelle.
Thanks, Rochelle.
It's 8:41. Time now for another check on the weather. Terry, sunny skies ahead?
It is. Nothing but great news in store for us. As far as the forecast goes, it's looking great, above normal for this time of year, and will stay that way right through the week. Our current conditions right now, it's sitting at 9 degrees here in Winnipeg. It has dropped slightly for Portage, 5 degrees right now, 6 in Morden. Moving a little bit further north, though, you can see northern Manitoba is waking up to some incredible temperatures. 12 for Island Lake and Lynn Lake, 11 right now in Thompson, 8 for Churchill, not bad at all. Here's a look at our radar, and you can see we have a little bit of cloud coverage right here over central Manitoba. In Winnipeg, though, we're in the clear, lots of sunshine, and it's going to pretty much stay that way. Even this cloud coverage that is going through just bypassing us here in Winnipeg until the overnight hours when it just lightly covers us. But for the most part, lots of sunshine is expected. And this is going to continue.
continue on right into tomorrow. Tomorrow evening still looking very good and clear. And you can see in our long-range forecast that things are also looking very good. Look at this. Lots of sunshine expected for today. 22 degrees, well above normal. 24 expected for Tuesday. 23 for Wednesday. And in fact, even the latter part of the week looking very good. Cooling ever so slightly, but still staying above normal for this time of year. Time for us to be...
Monday on Consumer Watch.
More Canadians are finding bargain real estate in the U.S. Consumer Watch's Karen Rosnick explores what you need to know to ensure your deal doesn't go south.
Consumer Watch, Monday on CTV News. Wake up with Kris, Eleanor Coopsammy, and Terry Apostle. The latest news, weather, and traffic. CTV Morning Live. Weekday mornings from 6 to 9. Smart ideas from Manitoba Hydro.
You can't talk about energy efficiency without talking about insulation. Insulation is one of the most important, yet most overlooked aspects of being power smart. A properly insulated home will help keep you comfortable all year long, as well as save you money in energy costs. Adequate levels of insulation act as an important layer of protection against the outside elements and help keep your home cooler in summer, warmer in winter. Power Smart insulation levels save energy and the environment. For more information on insulating, call Manitoba Hydro at 1-888-MB-HYDRO and ask for booklets 2 and 3 or go online at hydro.mb.ca.
This smart idea brought to you by Manitoba Hydro Power Smart and CTV.
People with type 2 diabetes or pre-diabetes don't have to give up their favorite foods or prepare separate family meals or treats.
And more than ever before, food companies like Kraft are committed to helping adults and children enjoy healthy eating. So here's a delicious recipe for turkey apple sliders that everyone can enjoy. They're easy to make and fun to eat. Start by heating the barbecue to medium high. Mix ground turkey, a grated Granny Smith apple, crushed whole wheat crackers, thyme, and sage, then shape into small patties and barbecue. Garnish with a whipped dressing, add the burger, and a piece of light cheese.
If you'd like more delicious recipes like this that are also approved by the Canadian Diabetes Association, check out our website.
Until next time, keep fit and have fun.
Body break. Body break.
Get breaking news sent straight to your desktop with CTV News at Work and the day's top stories on Twitter. Visit ctvwinnipeg.ca. Manitoba's news leader covers the stories you need to watch. And the best way to see them is just a click away. Visit ctvwinnipeg.ca.
Hi, Don Carson with Crypto Lifestyles. New for 2011 in our Master Spa line is our LSX 1000. It's a great five-year warranted spa. You gotta have it. Crypto Lifestyles.
It's 8:45. Good morning. 9 degrees. Look at traffic moving at the forks. You're watching CTV Morning Live. A trial is slated to start today into the killing of an Interlake man murdered back in 2007. 43-year-old Ivan Radokash was found murdered in his home near Inwood in September 2007. RCMP say he died of blunt force trauma. A total of six people were charged in his death, including Radokash's ex-wife, who was charged with conspiracy to commit murder. CTV's Stacey Ashley will be at the courthouse today. We'll have more on the trial later today on CTV News. Winnipeg police are investigating after a body washed up along the banks of the Red River. Yesterday afternoon, the body was found in the water. Right now, police aren't giving any details about the gender or age of the person. We do know emergency crews were called out to the 2100 block of Henderson Highway near Knowles Avenue just before 2. Details are still emerging. Police won't say if it's connected to the drowning of 6-year-old Nathaniel Thorasi. He disappeared beneath the ice back in December. His body hasn't been found. The Winnipeg Police Service Underwater Search and Recovery Unit is part of the investigation, which is continuing. One of Russell Williams' Williams' sexual assault victims has filed a lawsuit against him. Williams' ex-wife and the Ontario Provincial Police are also being named in that legal filing. According to the Toronto Star, Laura Massicott is seeking more than $7 million in damages for pain, suffering, and mental distress. Massicott tells the Star that following her assault, police said she had to remain in restraints used by Williams as an OPP photographer documented the scene. Williams was sentenced to life in prison last fall for the murders of Corporal Mary France Como and Jessica Lloyd, along with other crimes. A group of Winnipeg volunteers are trying something a little new to help families reunite with their dogs. It's a Facebook page called Winnipeg Lost Dog Alert. As soon as a dog is reported missing on the site, a picture, description, and where the dog was last seen is sent out to a network of people. The volunteers then start searching for the lost pet. The group says they found 50 lost dogs since the beginning of the year. The Winnipeg Jets play the Ottawa Senators tonight in St. John's, Newfoundland, home of the Jets' AHL affiliate, the Whitecaps, after a weekend of losses. The Jets took on Carolina in Carolina yesterday afternoon, and it was a tough one for the Jets. Carolina walked away with a shutout. Final score was 4-0. Jets fired 36 shots at Cam Ward, but couldn't beat the Canes goalie. With the loss, the Jets are 1-3 in the preseason, losing all three games on the road.
It's 8:47. Well, it's no secret that the housing bust south of the border has been a boon for Canadians looking to buy property in the U.S., but the days of rock-bottom prices and a wealth of supply may be actually over. As CTV's Consumer Watch reporter Karen Rosnick shows you now, Canadians looking to buy U.S. property should take more into consideration besides just the sun.
It had pretty much everything wanted in a spa.
Everything Jim and Betty Balance wanted in a California home at a price they could afford.
Palm Desert. It was just one that we loved, so it was time, and the dollar was strong.
They bought back in 2008. A strong dollar combined with a sinking U.S. housing market meant great deals and plenty of homes to choose from. Now it seems things have changed.
A lot of the supply is gone or is going. The demand is very high.
Former Winnipegger Diane Olson is a realtor based in Arizona. She holds information sessions across the country, packed with curious Canadians looking at buying property in the U.S. She says there's still deals south of the border, just fewer of them.
What's happening in our market is a lot of people are coming in and seeing the opportunities and taking advantage of them.
This U.S. tax specialist says she receives a steady stream of calls from Canadians looking at buying homes in the U.S.
These, a lot of people are going in and buying multiple 5 to 10 properties and renting them out and using that as an investment.
But says when it comes to investing in U.S. property, Canadians need to be aware of the tax implications.
Now you're earning income in the U.S. and you need to pay your fair share of tax in the U.S. if that's the case.
For example, Canadians earning income on a U.S. property are subject to a 30% withholding tax on the rent. That can be avoided by claiming it on a U.S. income tax return. Market fluctuations or a weakening loonie are also things to consider, as are non-resident taxes, which vary state to state.
If you're going to buy property, make sure you understand what you're getting into.
Jim Ballen says his decision to buy property in California was a lifestyle choice, not based as an investment, but says being informed about U.S. home ownership has still paid off. Karen Rosnick, CTV News, Winnipeg.
Well, Consumer Watch reporter Karen Rosnick joins us now, as she will every Monday when you have your feature, which
That's
airs
right.
on Monday. So, you know, I'm just wondering, the people are looking to invest property in the U.S., and, you know, the areas, Sunbelt is very popular, you know. Mm-hmm. Are there other areas to buy other than that?
Well, in the Sunbelt, that's where people, Canadians in particular, are going to be buying the property. As for what areas are better to buy in, Diane Olson, the real estate agent, said basically, if you're going to buy a cheap property in the U.S., look to the cheapest property in your own city and go, do you really want to buy there? So that being said, that's where the bidding wars are happening. She said that 10 to 12 offers are going on, very low-income houses that people are then turning over as investments to rent out. And
so you're bidding against other Canadians?
Possibly, yeah, exactly. But in the higher-end market, like where Jim Balance and his wife
right.
have a property in Palm Beach, he says those properties have been fairly stable as far as prices. So the key is location, location, location. So if
right.
you're going to buy a property and you want to make money off of it, make sure that you're buying in a good area where there's schools, recreation facilities.
Right, for resale.
Exactly.
good idea. Very good advice. Thanks very much, Karen.
You're welcome.
It's Karen Rosnick, our Consumer Watch reporter here at CTV. It's time now to check in with Terry Apostle and take a look at weather again.
And you can see by taking a look at our live cam right now, 9 degrees outside, very clear morning, winds from the south at 17 kilometers an hour, 93% humidity, lots of sunshine in store for us today. And our satellite map basically says the same thing. No cloud coverage showing up to block the sun. Lots of sunshine in store for us. Here's a breakdown of what we can expect today. By 9 a.m., hoping to get up to 10 degrees. By noon, up to 18, and reaching our high today by 22 degrees. And today, winds will be from the south between 20 and 30 kilometers an hour. The long-range forecast also looking very, very good. 22 for today, 24 for tomorrow, 23 for Wednesday. All of these temperatures above normal. By the middle of the week, we've got that high-pressure ridge above us starting to move a little bit eastward, bringing us slightly cooler temperatures by Thursday, but still staying above normal right into the weekend. And on our drive this morning, keep in mind a couple of trouble spots. Lights stuck York at Hargrave. Things are piling up through there. And a crash northbound McGregor at Burroughs causing some delays. But we've got Jesse out on the streets. Jesse, how's your drive going?
Well, good morning, Terry. Just off of Osborne as we approach Confusion Corner. I want to thank everybody for traffic tips today. Traffic flowing very nicely as we approach 9 o'clock. Meantime, it's time for breakfast now. I'm going to go to a gas station and buy Doritos because the man that invented Doritos passed away. So here's a crunch for you, sir. Here's a crunch for you. Stay tuned. More CTV Morning Live after the break.
My spidey senses are tingling.
The truth is sometimes stranger than fiction.
Our killer is a superhero.
NYPD, do not move a muscle.
Unless you can move faster than a speeding bullet.
This man, he's our killer.
And it takes a seasoned writer.
How cool was that?
With special skills.
Our killer is the writer of this comic book.
NYPD, take off that mask.
To read between the lines.
I did not see that coming.
An all-new Castle. Tonight at 10, 9 central on CTV.
Listen, they never sent us any bloody jeeps, never mind artillery. Stop the Jets. The Japs are all over us. We're going outside now before they burn the place down. Come on, lads. Osborne, give us a cover.
Sir.
He's down, sir.
Lawson's down. So's Hennessy.
All right, fix bayonets. We move out of my orders. Got grenade!
Our troops in Hong Kong were the first Canadians to see combat in the Second World War. And the war's first Victoria Cross for Canada was awarded posthumously to Sergeant Major John Osborne of Winnipeg.
With the WestJet RBC World MasterCard, you earn WestJet dollars on every purchase. Apply today and receive a welcome bonus of 350 WestJet dollars. That's 350 WestJet dollars to use just like cash to make their lowest fares even lower. And one WestJet dollar equals $1 towards travel with WestJet. Simple.
Apply now at rbc.com/WestJet or call 1-800-ROYAL-11. Offer expires November 14th, 2011. Some conditions and restrictions apply.
Women love to touch, which is why we love Purex. One touch tells us Purex is pure comfort.
This weekend at The Brick, take 20% off our ticket price on all furniture. Plus, for 96 hours only, take an additional 10% off all furniture. And do not pay for 24 months on everything in the store. Till Sunday only at The Brick.
The Easter Seals Million Deals Lotto is here. Your chance to win $3 million cash. Buy two tickets, get one free today. Call 988-3333 or visit EasterSealsMillionDeals.com.
It's 8:56. Time to bring in Kristen at the web desk. And your goal at this time is to send us on our day with a smile. So what do you have for us today?
Well, I like to call it a wave I caught while surfing the web. And it involves, appropriately, a little bit of water today.
Okay.
We have some sunshine to soak up the rest of this week. And who would have thought you could maybe even do some pool time in the water? So for all the kids in Winnipeg and Manitoba, I dare you to send me a video that looks like this. It's from HTH Pools, and this is called the Bellagio reenactment.
Oh,
and here they come. Amazing.
Oh,
so
awesome.
I would like to see this going on in Manitoba pools. I'd like to drive down the road and see geysers in backyards.
Oh,
there it is.
So
isn't that
they're
great?
They're so serious.
Well, they're concentrating, Elanor.
Okay, goodness. I thought kids were supposed to have fun in the pool.
That's amazing. I wonder what kind of music they were playing to that.
Yeah.
So there you have it. I'm going to provide that every day at around this time. So tune in.
Thanks a lot
Thanks
for that,
Kristen. Well, tune in tomorrow to CTV Morning Live. CTV political reporter Jeff Keel will be asking NDP leader Greg Selinger your questions leading up to Election Day, October 4th.
And of course, we'll have another clue for you to enter in the Cirque du Soleil Michael Jackson giveaway. Thanks a lot for joining us this morning.
Bye, everyone.
Have a good one.
Facts about the multi-link coil rear suspension in the Ram 1500. Fact, it tames the drive, not the driver. Fact, it pulls its weight with whatever you're pulling. Fact, only the Ram full-size pickup truck has it. Guts, glory, Ram.
Every second counts. Every step is important. Every opinion matters. Every piece adds up. Every breath, every ounce, every touch. Every vote counts. On October 4th, cast your vote in Manitoba's provincial election because you count.
There are 16 fresh-picked oranges squeezed into each carton of Tropicana Pure Premium. And absolutely no space for added sugar, water, or preservatives. Tropicana. We put the good in morning.
Routines are so routine. Hey, Steve. You get stuck in them day in, day out. Doing, hey Steve, the same thing, day in, day out. Sometimes you don't even realize, hey Steve, what a rut you're in. Then you try something new, like Tetley Infusions. And suddenly everything's different. Hey Steve.
Hey to you.
Hey to you.
Hey to you.
Break your beverage routine with natural, real-brewed Tetley Infusions and Facebook us.
I see that the field experience and the studio experience all comes together, and I will be bringing the field to the studio, if you will, because it's what I know, and I think that's what I'm excited about.
The following program deals with mature subject matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
Hey, it's Anderson. Today on the program, one of the most shocking stories I think I've ever heard. I've been doing the research for a couple of days now, and I still can't believe that this happened. It's a story about a brother and sister, twins, who endured the worst forms of physical and sexual abuse. And no one in their family, in their school, in their neighborhood stopped it. This brother and sister are so strong, and they're so determined. They survived. And today on the show, you're going to see how they did it.